Thank you. Hello and welcome to High Rollers. These guys have been winding me up non-stop.
It's our job.
As you'll notice, I am not your Dungeon Master Sherlock Humes. I am your Dungeon Master Kim Richards. I almost forgot my surname there. That's really...
Your surname's Richards?
Yeah.
That's weird.
It is, isn't it? Yours is Jones.
Yeah, that's pretty normal.
Duncan Jones.
Yeah,
so Mark and Trot and Smithy off being wizards in fields this weekend. And Katie is enjoying some time with her sister. So send us some love on Twitter. So I am running a horror one-shot, and these are my victims of today, starring with Merchandise Mikey.
Or just Mikey, as I prefer to be called.
Well, people like to know, like, what are you doing? Who are you?
I pull the strings behind the scenes. I basically just have to do anything Duncan asks me to do. So I buy groceries, book his taxis, clean his floors.
Clean his hair.
Yeah, clean his hair.
He grooves it. Yeah. Pulls the little ticks out.
Yeah, so it's the best of the world, so.
And we've got Tom as well, who's been Reynard on the main High Roller streams.
Hey, hi.
Hi.
Hey. Yeah.
For those who don't know, Tom is also one of our editors.
Yeah.
Who do you edit for?
Oh, you name it.
Do you edit for this one?
No. Okay, don't name that one.
You name it, and it's not that one.
All the others.
Everyone else. Yeah. Hat Films?
Okay, not that one.
Not that
okay,
one.
Lewis?
Yeah. No, okay. Well, not the main channel.
Okay.
Oh, fine. Double Dragon, Triforce, Sips.
Civ.
Civ.
Pyrion as well?
Pyrion. Some others, just
basically all the really important people.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow, Civ is super important.
Civ is crazy important.
Hasn't asked me to be on it yet, so it's not important.
Maybe you should learn how to play Civ.
Last but definitely not least,
maybe I should learn to play Civ.
Some homeless guy down the streets.
Yeah, I'm homeless. these guys found me.
Look at your hair.
What?
What is going on with that?
What's wrong with it?
I mean, I know we hung out last weekend, and I feel like it's grown. Like, even longer. Like, what's your secret?
Hair extensions.
Yeah?
It's really subtle.
Yeah? Pretty good, actually. What are you aiming for? Are you aiming for, like, death metal length?
Oh, I'm going to go down to the ground.
That's going to take
like, cousin it.
Yeah. Go for the cousin
really
it look, yeah.
Matted and gross.
Nah, I'm washing it.
That's going to be...
At the moment, it takes me, like, half an hour to like wash and dry my hair every day.
No, it takes me half an hour to wash and dry Doug's hair every day.
that's why I'm always late. That's why, if you ever hear Shin talking about why I'm late, that's why. Because like, I take ages on my hair.
Do you have to spend loads of time in front of the mirror as well doing the slow motion, like, because I'm worth it?
No.
No? Yeah. I would if I had hair like that. It's magnificent.
Thank you.
What I'm trying to say.
Do you want it? You can have it.
your hair is magnificent too, Kim.
Is
don't
it?
Put yourself down.
No, it's
fantastic.
A bit, I don't know.
Where's the red gone?
Yeah, exactly. Now that I've taken the red out, I have just no personality at all.
Just boring.
Yeah, just boring.
Got kind of like a little bit of like a
last bit of dye and bleach. But anyway, that's not what we're here for. We're here for some horror. Are you guys ready for some horror?
Horror.
Yeah. So for those of you who don't know, I've done this twice before, yeah. When Mark is off being a wizard in the field, I take over and do a little horror one-shot. I say horror, it's pretty silly. I don't know, think like B-movie and stuff like that.
What with the bee and the woman? Can I be the bee?
I would have thought you'd be the woman. So it's gonna be a pretty silly 3 hours. Hopefully we'll have some spooks. Hopefully we'll have some laughs. Depends on you guys. The general setup is we have a group of supernatural investigators. I still need to come up with a name for this spook squad, like, because you know we've had Matt, Kat, and Katie, and you were part of it before as well. So, but I don't really know what to call the investigative society. Like, if you can just think of that.
Maybe that can be like a side mission for today.
Yeah.
Maybe it's like a defining moment.
It's gonna be our first like time together.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So you're part of a wider organisation of supernatural investigators who get called out to investigate spooky going on.
Okay.
So we're in the same world as the main High Rollers campaign. So we are in the same world as Juto, Cam, Elora, Reynard, Trell, all of that, Korak.
But I don't want to live on this world!
Wow. So it's very much the same world of kind of like gnomes and dragons and dragonborn and ogres and wonderful, fantastical, what would you call that? Mythical?
Fantasy. High fantasy.
High fantasy.
Yeah.
Beings. But yeah, and so you're part of this investigation and you have been called to this place, and we'll go into a bit more of where we are in a second. But first of all, do you guys want to introduce yourselves and what character you are playing?
Okay. Do you want to go first, Duncan?
Hey, I'm Scruffy. Is that a good accent? I'm going to have to work on
well,
that
Well, you're going to have to like commit to
it. I'm Scruffy. I'm Scruffy.
I don't know. You're going to have to commit scruffy. For 3 hours.
I'm Scruffy.
Yeah.
And I've got a pet wolf called Doobie. Scruffy and Doobie. I am a ranger, level 8.
Do you want to tell anything?
I used to be, well, I am a part-time cook because this whole mystical adventuring thing doesn't make me much money, I'll be honest. Because I don't usually end up finding out the answers, that's the problem. I run away, and then I go like, no, I can't do that, it's too scary.
So you don't really solve
any cases?
I'm a bit
of a wuss, really. I sold a couple,
yeah,
but only one they're like,
really
pretty
obvious.
Simple.
Yeah, okay.
Who did it? There's him.
Like that. Yeah, okay.
He's there, he's got the knife, he's got blood on his hands, it's obvious.
Okay, so that's Scruffy and your pet wolf, Doobie.
Doobie, yeah. He's, he's a glutton.
Okay.
Yeah, he's got a flaw where if he sees any food, he will do anything he can to eat that food.
What Doobie snacks.
Okay.
Yeah. For the purposes of this campaign, I'm renaming Goodberries to Doobie snacks.
Okay.
Nice.
Well, I hope nobody in the audience is still guessing as to who you've based your characters on. Tom.
My name is Vern Dupree, a devout follower of the god Pelor, and I'm here to exorcise demons from the nearby wherever we're going. May the power of Pelor compel you.
Pelor.
Yeah. God of healing and the sun.
Two things.
That.
Green.
Yeah.
Two things, yeah.
Jeez.
So I'm a cleric preacher who specializes in like seances and exorcisms. And I got a whole lot of spells to do that.
Yeah, for some reason I decided to let you guys be level 8. And then when I started hearing about all the stuff that you've got, I'm like, hmm.
Well, I don't know what half the stuff is.
Well, that's good. That's good.
I've got like literally a printout of the Unearthed Arcana Ranger here with all the, like.
Yeah, you're probably not going to need it.
It's like 6 pages of abilities that I've got.
Probably not going to need it. Probably not going to need it. Cool. Okay, so that is Vern Dupree. Vern Dupree. Are you and do you believe in ghosts, or are you like? You know?
Well, I exercise them, so I've like dealt with them before.
Okay.
Sorry.
And you've even got your own. Oh, your little priest collar.
That's a nice touch.
Yeah. Nice.
Well, it's where I've written down my spells.
It's nice to see someone making an effort.
There you go.
Hey. I've got scruffy hair.
Actually, yeah, that's true. That is true. So, Mikey.
So, I am a forest gnome, a rogue forest gnome, and my name is Mr. Kerr, Mr. F.A. Kerr. And my profession in life is I'm a medium. So, perhaps you've got a relative or a sibling or someone that's passed away, and you're desperate to ask them a question from beyond the veil or whatever it's called in this world for a sum, like it's a very expensive process, and for a little bit of coin I can help you out, I can help you talk to the dead.
Yeah.
So you like stand on a stage, sort of point to a person.
Sometimes I do it with big audiences, or if someone's rich enough I'll give them a one-on-one sitting and I can help them commune. I can help very desperate people with a lot of money.
Rich, desperate
people get the answers they desperately need.
Yeah.
And somehow I've ended up in this squad of whatever
supernatural investigators
because it pays well apparently, and I like money, so
yes. Well, there we go. You've got some cases for it to pay off, you know.
What's your name again? F.A. Kerr.
F.A. Kerr.
Okay, Mr. Kerr.
Yeah,
Mr. Kerr.
Yeah, that's the one. You got it.
What does the F.A. stand for?
Fuck all.
Frog. I wish I'd thought of that. Technically, Duncan, it's Mr. Frog Alvin.
Alvin, that's a good name.
Yeah, there we go, for a forest name.
Kerr.
Frog Alvin, yeah, Frog.
Oh, alright.
It was in the book, alright.
Okay. It was in the gnome generator?
Yeah.
Right, okay, so you have been pulled together by the Supernatural Investigators Organization. That's the name we're going for this time. And you find yourself outside the Overlook Inn. It is nighttime, and what you're looking at is a fairly typical medieval inn. It's got dark timber beams, white walls, a thatch roof, and some kind of dim oil lanterns kind of glowing faintly outside. And the faded sign of the Overlook Inn is just, you know, creaking in the breeze. There's a light snow falling, so it's a little bit cold. And there are flower pots and hanging baskets outside, but they're all just full of dead flowers. Like, you kind of get the impression looking at the outside of the inn that things are a little bit run down, a little bit, you know, forgotten. You know, it's like a little bit of a forgotten inn.
Sort of like Duncan's flat.
Yeah, like aesthetic. Duncan's flat, but, you know.
You should clean it better, Mike, come on.
And as you breathe in, as well as the kind of the smell of the snow that's falling, you can kind of get the tang of stale beer and musty wood.
Yeah, I can smell that now.
Well, yeah. My immersion is like really peak right now.
I'm there. I feel like I'm there.
Okay. And what you know from the board of investigators is that you have been called here by a Mr. Jaquil to investigate a spate of hauntings at the inn that have resulted in some disappearances and deaths. So
Mr.
in your pop,
Jaquil,
yeah.
What will he do?
So if you wanna just like move your, just move.
Not,
just,
not knock it. I'll just go in.
Burst in.
Okay.
This is the SIAO. So what you
SIAO? We're here to improve your optimization search engines.
Dwarf behind the counter.
It's not. He's in a room. That's a room.
Oh really? Oh,
that's
no
actually
here.
An upturned bed, but it is like a counter. But I couldn't find enough like minis.
Is there like a bell on the?
Yes, there's a bell. So yeah, the front lobby, you know, is pretty much what you expected looking from the outside. It's all a bit run down, a bit kind of gloomy. There is kind of carpet underfoot, and it's a bit dusty and sticky. It's got a really obnoxious kind of geometrical pattern in it that's kind of driving you a little bit crazy the more that you look at it.
Look up.
You know, there's animal heads on the walls. You look up and there are animal heads on the walls.
The
and
carpet
a bit,
is also on the ceiling.
It's also on the ceiling.
Are there any like creepy paintings watching us?
Yeah, like some kind of faded distant relative. Maybe you can't even make out what race the person is.
Oh, like, so if I move around the room and their eyes following me everywhere.
It's kind of, it's very gloomy. It's very, not very well maintained, and it's a bit like, and you see in front of you a wooden counter with a rusty old bell on it.
Can I? Yeah, I'll go forward and just ring the bell. I guess I'm the weird blue guy.
Tool guy.
Yeah. So I'm gonna ring that bell.
Okay. So from out from a door behind, if someone could push him forward, from behind the counter comes a dwarf. He's very stocky. Looks about middle-aged for a dwarf. He's got a huge bulbous nose and some really thick glasses that kind of like, you know, magnify his eyes. So he's got like huge looking eyes. And yeah, he comes out. He moves very nervously. Like he's just kind of a bit like, you know, what's going on? Like kind of, there's something very nervous about him. Yes, yes, hello.
Greetings. Dwarf, I've forgotten, I'm doing Reynard.
You were like middle Americana preacher.
Well, hello there, dwarf.
There you go.
We have been sent by Mr. Jaquil to investigate some strange goings on in these here parts. That's a Texan, eh?
I am Mr. Jaquil. I am the owner of this establishment. Yes, you were part of the supernatural investigators, yes?
Yeah, indeed we are. Little man.
bit offensive. I don't go around calling you tall man, do I? Squishy human.
He calls me tiny all the time. I'm sorry about him. He's not very good with people. Yes, Mr. Jaquil, it's a pleasure to meet you. We've been dispatched here. I'm Mr. Kerr, no doubt you've heard of me. Famous medium psychic. This is my accomplice. Mr. Derp Dupree, and back there, my companion with the dog is Mr. Scruffy.
Scruffy's my name.
Bonding! Yeah. Team Bonding!
So what's the dog doing right now?
Doobie's just like sniffing around.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, how's Doobie in this, you know? Is he used to?
He's looking a bit spooked out.
Yeah?
A bit scared. He can actually talk, by the way.
What?
Oh. Yeah.
But in dog, which is a language only I know.
Okay, nice. So he's a wolf that can speak dog?
Yeah.
You didn't think that through, did you?
I didn't want to pick a big canine. Dog because they're rubbish.
Okay. We're here to investigate the paranormal activities around this tavern.
You see, I run a fine establishment here. My accent's totally gone there. Sorry, my livers.
Okay, it's gonna happen.
This always happens. I'm not Mark. I'm not good enough at my accents. It just happens. We've had some hauntings. Terrible. Just hauntings everywhere. I'm trying to run an inn here, you know, with some rooms and lodging, and everyone's just running screaming. It's terrible.
Hauntings.
Yes, we've had customers disappear, and we've had deaths.
Deaths. Really? Deaths?
Yeah.
Are there any other...
I don't like this, dupes!
Are there any other supernatural events going on around here? Objects moving around?
Yes.
Okay, some others...
so
list them.
Go back to these deaths. Like, how many deaths have there been exactly?
Two. I'm trying to whisper because I don't...
Okay, yes, we understand. Don't worry, we understand. So you've had two deaths, and who exactly died?
Customers.
Are
these big, powerful, brawly customers who can defend themselves, or are these...
Well, one was an elven lady, can't remember her name, and then the other one was an orc.
An orc died.
Is orcs around?
Do you not keep a ledger for all the customers that...
It's disappeared. Things are disappearing.
Interesting. Oh, can't come up with your names. Okay.
Bob.
Bob the orc. I don't like orcs.
Okay, and how many customers did you say has disappeared?
Lots.
Okay.
Lots.
Lots.
Where did they go? Does anyone know?
Perhaps if this is a better kept establishment, maybe people wouldn't leave quite so often.
I'm sorry?
I mean, I've stayed in some dives before, but really this place is something else.
Well, I can't help it. Some people like to stay in a haunted establishment, you know?
You know?
I don't have much money here, you know? Not everywhere has enough customers to pay for things.
Okay.
Out of interest, have you been advertising yourself as a haunted establishment to gain more customers?
No.
Okay. Cool.
I pull off her mask! It was her!
If you want to roll for anything, and remember you can do that.
Oh, yeah. In that case, can I check, what would I... Insight, I suppose, to check if he's lying about that one? Five.
You think he's definitely nervous about something. He's really nervous, but you kind of believe what he's saying.
Okay. May I ask why you kept the place still open if you know there are people going missing and dying?
It's my livelihood. I've got nothing else.
Okay.
I've got my son and me, and I have the family. It's my business.
How did they die?
They're screaming.
Screaming?
Blood. This is the cleaning. God. I can't get the blood out of the
sheets. Oh, God. Zoinks. blood and screaming.
Are there any wounds? Any
scratch marks. Glowing. Bite marks.
Glowing?
Clawing, claws.
Oh, clawing. Okay.
And that was on both of the corpses?
Yes. Oh.
Some kind of beast.
Sounds horrific. And sorry, you said this is your livelihood. Have you worked here forever?
Yes.
Has this always been
your family? It's my family inn.
Forever, yeah. Forever.
So much.
Dwarves live forever, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, he probably is older than you. Squishy
Well,
human.
I'm only 22, so.
Yeah, squishy human, he's definitely older than you. Probably not as old as you. How old are you?
200 years old, yes. I settled on. I knew you'd come and see that.
You were like, I don't need an age. And I was like, yeah, you do.
How recently did these people die?
The last one was probably a week ago.
And the one before that?
2 weeks.
Has anyone gone missing since the last death?
No. I don't know. Like, there are people sleeping upstairs now. They might be gone already.
God. Seems to not care.
Do you charge in advance?
Yes. I'm a dwarf.
Have you had any guests, like suspicious looking or different people who you haven't usually
seen? Everyone's
suspicious. Everyone's
suspicious. Especially humans.
No one sticks out. No one's out of the ordinary.
No, not really. Just the usual run of the mill travellers. And you know, you sometimes, because word gets out that you know you're haunted or worse. You get the occasional, you know, oh, I'm gonna see the haunting. you do get the occasional kind of ghost tourism, you know, that kind of thing.
All helps business, right?
Yes, it's all good
for business.
What a lively looking place.
These bodies, are they available for us to look at anywhere, or have they been?
No,
of course not.
They're buried long ago. The only thing is, it happens at night. So you're going to have to stay overnight.
Night now?
Yes. I did request that you came at night because that's when they come out. There's no use during the day. You're going to have to stay overnight.
Stay here overnight?
Yes.
In this tavern?
Yes.
You expect me to stay in this tavern?
Yes, well, there's lodgings upstairs. Yes.
Mr. F.A. Kerr stay in an establishment like this?
That's what your investigation said you would do, yes.
You need to prove yourself to be a loyal ghost hunter.
Oh, well. I mean, if my reputation doesn't, I will make sure of that tonight.
you're still holding seances, so maybe you could do that and communicate and call them.
Yes, perhaps the seance is in order.
Yeah. Are there any particular rooms that you suspect may be haunted?
Yes, room number 2, room number 3, and room number 7. So, if you don't mind, I've already made arrangements for you to stay, but yes.
In those rooms?
Yes.
In separate rooms.
Do we have to?
Yes. Every other room is taken.
Oh jeez. I've got to stay in a haunted room?
You are an investigator in the supernatural, yes?
Well, I do mysteries. I don't know about...
This is a mystery.
Ghosts?
People have gone. Died.
Oh my God!
What's going on?
I didn't sign up for this.
you're each going to have to pay.
Pay?
Well, this is an inn. I can't just let you stay there for free.
We're trying to rid this place of ghosts, ghouls, wights, and beasts. And you're charging us? You're making us pay you?
Well, consider it a deposit. I'm not saying it's going to happen to you, but I mean, then I'll
need them. There's no need for me to pay a deposit. Trust me, we're certain to get this done. I think I make a persuasion roll. Make a roll. Here we go. Oh. It's a 9 because I'm an expert in that.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. Well,
it's still not quick enough.
I rolled a 2, so. So you guarantee you can get this done?
Oh, I'm certain. I'm certain of the fact. 100%. I never get it wrong.
Okay. Well, here's your key, and I give you. So you get number 7. You get number 3, and you get number 2.
Number 2.
Spooky number 3.
I'm gonna need a number 2 soon.
and I just asked, you know, obviously, you know, staff, don't go to the staff where, you know, no going to the staff areas.
Our investigations may take us anywhere in this tavern. We may need to investigate any areas to get to the bottom of this.
No.
Why not?
Because staff, we have to run things.
What do you think's big? We're gonna do here?
We won't get in the way of the staff. We just need access.
Are there any like keys, like not room keys? So there's. I'm assuming it's a hotel. There's gonna be like a thing full of keys. Are there any which look like they're like staff keys?
There isn't a board of. He's got some keys on his belt.
He's got some keys on his belt.
Yeah.
So he's talking to these guys.
He's quite low down as well.
I'm incredibly low down.
Oh, that's true.
I'm
low. Yeah, he's a gnome. I'm
he's
tiny. Gnome.
Do you want me to distract him?
Yeah, okay, you distract him.
Okay, what should I distract him with? I'm already sure.
I'll tell you what. I'm going to use... So I'm a forest gnome, so I have minor illusion. I'm going to make the sound of, like, a ruckus coming from the tavern. So it's, like, fighting. Things which he maybe perhaps needs to go and like attend to or something like this. So there's hollering, there's shouting, there's not screaming, because he isn't like that, but there's like a general like drunken brawl taking place.
A drunken brawl?
Yeah, it's the sound of a drunken brawl.
I'm gonna say, make your roll. So what roll do you
so
need to make?
So that's a minor illusion.
Minor illusion.
So I think, do you want me to double check?
It'd probably be like a charisma or something like that.
It's like, so it uses my int, but I don't know how you save against it off the top of my head.
I just wonder if I should make you make a persuasion.
I don't think that's how it works in minor illusions.
No,
I'm
not. Just ask the man will hear the sound.
He basically, as long as if he fails this, then he believes that he hears what I say.
I don't think he has to fail anything.
Okay, if a creature uses its action to examine the sound or image, the creature can determine that as an illusion with a successful intelligence check against my spell save DC. So whatever that means. Mark Humes, where are
Damn
you now?
You! No. Well, the only thing I would say though is that he knows his establishment and he knows the patrons that are currently in
so
the
he's
bar
not,
area. So I would say whatever
right,
you
I'll
have to do,
him.
It's okay. At disadvantage.
Yeah. Okay.
Because he knows who's in there.
Okay, but you need to roll. So I think you roll advantage against my spell save DC.
Okay. So and you want me to make an intelligence?
Yeah. Minor illusion. The creature uses action to examine the sound. The creature can determine its illusion with a successful. So you make an intelligence check against my spell
just a
save
straight up
DC.
Intelligence check. Okay.
Yeah.
And I get advantage.
A spell save.
What would it? What would it be off the top of your head, Duncan?
I think it's.
Is it just my int?
It's your, whatever your bonus. Spell casting stat is.
So it's intelligence. So it's 14.
So it's 10 plus that, I think.
Well, 10 plus 2, so it'd be 12.
I think so.
I think mine was 8 plus. Because my spell save is.
It might add your proficiency as
oh,
well.
Oh, then again, my spell save is 14, and that's.
And you've got a plus 4.
When I asked these guys to create their characters, I told them to check with Mark before he went off. Because I was like, I can't help you.
This is the one thing. It would be 12. So what did you roll?
14.
Yep, you did it.
So if you want to play it out, describe it for me.
So you hear this noise and you assume this like hollering. Someone's like, oh, can I swear in this? No. Someone's called someone short
wanker.
Who is a gnome. Someone calls them a wanker.
Yeah, prick.
Someone says little man to a dwarf.
Well, Mr. Jesus Christ. Yeah. Well, so Jack Will's gonna kind of like just.
Huh? I bet you realise.
Scruffy, hearing the sounds of what sounds like a horrific fight happening next door, is going to run upstairs away as far away as he can
from it.
Oh, with
you?
It.
Oh, yeah. So
well, you're not going to go to the bar?
I'm going
to hang out at the bar.
Well, there's a fight in there. I'm not going to do a fight. It sounds scary.
He's just going to be like...
I was like, what is that noise?
You need to pay your fee, sir!
Hey, just come on. It's a fight!
Doesn't no, I don't think so. My voice has changed again. But I know it's just the old people, it'll settle down a bit, don't worry about it.
I come back down like poke around the corner. Oh, you sure?
I'll take you through, come on.
Oh jeez.
I was gonna say, you might wanna you might wanna go and have a drink first, you know. We are an inn, Overlook Inn, you know.
Sounds
most
fantastic.
Haunted. So perhaps you would like a drink first, you know.
What food do you serve?
Food.
That's good enough for me.
just food.
I'll take it.
Okay, and he's gonna lead the way. So he's handed out all your keys to you as well. But yeah, he's gonna lead the way.
Yeah.
So you're gonna go into the bar area. The bar area. And because this is a
Scoobs.
Dude
kind of pushes me in because I'm too scared to enter.
Yeah, he wants
there's
drink.
A fight in there.
Yeah.
And I see there's no fight.
Yeah.
Calm down a bit.
There's no fight going on. What you see is a pretty typical pub kind of area. Heavy wooden beams, sticky bar covered in, you know, beer, circular beer tankard stains. Bunch of, you know, kind of dull, discoloured drinking tankards hanging from nails. It stinks of stale beer. Like, you're pretty sure that, you know, the barrels here are pretty old.
Oh, no.
And there's a very kind of like a very small fire in the corner, you know, like a fireplace. Carpet sticking to your feet.
Yeah.
It's a bit gross. You see a couple of tables with kind of country folk types.
Yep.
Kind of just gathered around, and they're all kind of like, you know, just very quietly, very low murmur in the room where they're just kind of, you know, very very quiet conversation. They all look very like very rustic types.
Okay.
do any of them seem distracted as we, well, like, do they notice us come in?
A couple of them kind of just, but they barely look up at you, just like,
okay.
You can hear a little bit of like a, outsiders. And then in the bar, in the corner here, you can see a halfling woman working behind the bar. I couldn't find a halfling thing, and I thought, fine, she's got beer on the thing.
she's got stilts.
Yeah, and even though she's, you know, obviously quite small because she's halfling, she emits an aura of kind of no nonsense. Mm. Like, she kind of looks quite strong. She looks like she's got no time for idiots. And she's also got a toothpick, just like that she's just chewing on. Like, it's just hanging out the corner of her mouth, just like, she's just kind of like, you know, cleaning out a stein with a really greasy rag, and you're just kind of looking at it going, oh, what is that?
Nice.
Like, gross. And also on the side of the bar, you notice two little halfling children, twins. Ooh. Little twins. Twin
oh,
God. Girls.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Any sort of haunted looks in their eyes?
I don't know, do you want?
I can roll perception.
What would haunted look like?
I mean, there's like, you know, like Esper, the Pokemon?
Yeah.
Like just what? Wide eyes, just.
Anyone looking traumatized or like,
you know, chanting, holding a bloody knife, that sort of
thing. I'll tell you don't have to roll perception for that. I'll tell you, there's, you know, they're all just, it just looks like a normal village pub kind of, you know, you're not from round here type kind of scene. You know.
Broadchurch.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Can I look around and see what people are eating?
There's
human
kind
legs.
Of human remains.
Well, I am really hungry.
There's just you know, kind of typical pub food, kind of like big boards of bread and cheese, apples, like, you know, Plowman sandwich, that kind of thing.
Shit.
You know, very basic kind of.
Is there a table that's free?
There isn't a table, but there are seats. Like, these are seats.
Those barrels.
Yeah, at the bar.
I'm gonna sit on the barrels.
As you guys kind of walk in, you can notice like the patrons are kind of like looking at you, but kind of just bare, like, it's very hostile. Like, they're just kind of looking at you like.
Hoist tubes up onto the wrong.
City folk.
I'm ahead of here. But on the way, as we were following this bloke, can I try and pinch that set of keys hanging from his waist?
Yeah, you can. So that would be sleight of hand.
Okay, let's go. Plus six. So that'd be 21.
Okay. Yeah. So I guess because he's probably distracted because he's trying to be host and like I said, very nervous. Like, you know, he's kind of looking around everywhere, kind of like, you know, very nervously trying to look at everything. While everyone else seems really kind of like bored, almost a bit bored and a bit normal. Like, he's very kind of like, you know, just looking
jittery.
At shadows, jittery. Mm. Yeah, that's exactly the word. And as he's distracted, you just yoink.
Grab him.
Nice.
Yep. In the pocket. All right.
Wow.
Fantastic. I'm just gonna head over here.
La 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 la.
Sort of sit next to Duncan. Just imagine that's okay.
Okay.
Crap. Oh, there's a doge in the corner here, by the way.
Ooh.
But he's just looking like, he looks at your wolf and he's just like, dog.
Wolf says. Hello!
He's just a very old dog. He's just like, just gonna sit by the fire and just be an old dog.
What are you eating? You got any food? Ruff!
Just looking at him. He doesn't want to talk. He's the same as the human, the other patrons. He's just like, you're not from around here, mate.
Fucking city dogs.
City dogs. Glorified wolf.
And I think I'm gonna approach the Kiddlywinks.
Kiddlywinks?
The nice. Twins.
Okay. So they eye you up. They're twins. You know, dressed quite nicely, you know, light blue dresses. And they give you a stare, and everything they do is like in absolute synchronization.
Oh, right,
like,
okay.
You know, they've got that weird twin kind of like
mirror image.
Yeah. And they're just looking at, and they look like they have that stare that's kind of like a bit old, you know, just a really kind of world weary kind of like old by their time. And they're just staring at you.
Creepy.
Okay. blessing of Palor, children. We're here investigating some spooky phenomenons going on around here. Have you heard or seen anything?
Lots of things going on here, mate.
Very deep voice for children.
They both speak at the same time.
One of them speak. Actually, no. Let me retcon that voice because that was ridiculous. That's not what.
Get away, we spooky little girl.
Spooky around here, mate. That was the patron's voice. Right. How would they speak? They'd be like,
lots of things going on around here.
Yeah. In fact, could you just voice it?
Yeah. Okay. So I have the conversation.
Lots of spooky things going around here, sir. You're going to have to be more specific.
Have you heard any noises? Any things moving around?
Things that go bump in the night?
Things that go bump in the night?
Oh, yes.
Oh, God. Oddly sexual.
This is terrifying.
Are your parents around?
Our mother is working the bar.
Ah. So you live here with your mother, okay.
They kind of like look at each other and kind of like do a little giggle like and they're just going back to giving you that really creepy stare.
I'm not really sure how to navigate with these kids. Like, what am I going to get out of them?
Give them like a lollipop.
I haven't got any. I've got a wart skin.
That's going to cut it.
No, I've got nothing. I've got nothing I can give them. Just to... Do you like incense?
What?
They smell good.
They're just gonna stare at you. Just stare at you and just stare at you.
Got a blanket?
We've got blankets too, mister. We live here.
I got nothing.
I got them.
Kids these days, yeah. Like, wow, so spoiled. Yeah.
It's a good thing you have nothing, mister. You're going to die here.
Power of Palor compels you, demons!
just nothing. Whatever you were trying to do.
I just wanted to see if they would shimmy away or anything.
No,
like.
they don't even blink. Like, they just don't even blink.
Fine.
You're going to die here. And what? The other one goes, you better say your prayers, mister.
I do every night.
You better say your prayers. You better die with a clean conscience, mister. Are you going to go to heaven or hell?
Heaven.
Are you sure?
Certain.
Yeah?
Yeah, devout follower.
Because you're going to find out tonight.
Not like that.
Because you're going to die here.
What makes you say that?
And then you're going to stay here forever. And ever. And ever. And ever.
I'm going to leave these kids. I'm going to go to the bar next to these other guys because...
I haven't had any
no
of this.
No way.
Peace out.
Guys, I would not talk to those kids if I were you.
Really? What do they say?
Say we're gonna die.
Oh, jeez, yeah. What?
Stay here forever.
They know?
They're staring at you guys now. Like, they followed him kind of like, you know, and they're just staring at you, they're just staring at all of you, but with this unblinking kind of like...
Oh God.
They creeped me out, guys.
They creeped me out too. can I just get the bar lady's attention?
Yeah, she's just still cleaning.
She's still just cleaning.
Chewing a toothpick, yeah. Just like...
Excuse me?
Yep.
Sorry, I'm Mr. Kerr. These are my two compatriots. I don't know what they
Companions.
Are. Companions. My friends. But yeah, we're staying here tonight. We're awfully thirsty and very hungry. Perhaps you could sort us out some meals and a couple of drinks, perhaps?
I take a small leather pouch out of my pocket and I open it and there's a knife and fork inside. And I just, boom! And I look at her and I just stare and I go, give me the food!
She's just gonna raise an eyebrow.
Okay, and I take my pan in my pocket, and I slap a gold piece on the counter. Food! Food!
What do you want, mister?
Everything.
Everything.
She very slowly just kind of takes the coin, and shouts out back. All right, got one, full house. Come on.
Oh, full house.
Full house, I'll have a full house too, please.
Nay, that too.
I feel like I'm not really that hungry after talking to the kids. Like, I've completely like lost my appetite a little bit. Okay. I'm not hungry anymore, I'm just terrified.
Beer.
Squaffy! What about me? Oh, one more please.
Make that three.
Oh, you owe me. Hey, this is not you. I'm pointing at the dog.
Oh, right.
And you know, during this whole exchange, she hasn't moved. She's still like.
She's still just. I'll take a beer, please. And I'm sure my companions will too. Yeah. Perhaps you yourself would like a drink.
She's working.
You paying for it?
I've never been to a bar before.
I've been to a tavern.
You paying for it?
Of course.
Coin. Oh yeah, yeah, she really slowly, like, she does a really deep.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
She does a really deep sigh, kind of like a, you're really inconveniencing her right now, like a kind of, and then just slowly goes, pour out the beers, just dunks them on the table.
Including her own, wow, God, what a.
And after a little bit of time, another halfling male comes out, and he's holding platters of like plowman's sandwiches, bread, cheese. Yeah, he just kind of shufties them on the.
I start constructing an absolutely enormous sandwich. Just like this high.
There's a couple of like, you know, a couple of the regulars are just looking over at you like, safe. It's like you can hear them mumbling, kind of like, oh, not from around here.
May I take your name, please?
Who's asking?
Me.
And who are you?
I'm Vern Dupree, devout follower of the god Paylor.
So that meant to mean something.
I'm here investigating the evils that surround this tavern. I heard there may, I'm trying to keep this down from the rest of the tavern, just like, I heard there may have been a few deaths, people gone missing.
Yep.
Do you not care?
Nope.
Huh.
Still getting paid.
Those two children over there, are they yours?
Yep.
Yeah, I feel like the apple doesn't really fall far from there.
You met Tulip and Daffodil then?
Tulip and Daffodil.
Such pretty names for for such beautiful girls.
Such cursed children.
They are delightful.
And your name? Buttercup.
Dale. But you can call me Mrs. Grady.
Mrs.
Dale Grady.
Dale Grady. And Tulip Grady and Daffodil Grady. I'm not writing that down.
I'm just stuffing my face. Can't talk.
What did you see? What did you see? Good.
Are you not concerned for your well-being staying in a haunted place like this?
Nope. Don't seem to be coming after me and my girls.
I mean, based on the two victims so far, it seems to be attacking indiscriminately. Right.
Business is good.
The business certainly is good. It's booming in here. So, Del, how long have you actually worked here for?
Probably about 20 years now.
20 years. So I guess Tulip and Daffodil were born in this place.
Mm-hmm.
And grew up here.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, hell.
That's beautiful. It's fantastic. What fantastic environment to raise children. It really is. I'm enamored with this place. It's the best. The best tavern I've ever been to.
I feel like you need to roll like a persuasion on that one.
Roll a sarcasm.
Do you want to roll a
persuasion? Why the hell not? Let's go for it. That would be like a 19.
Yeah,
I'm pretty good at that.
Yeah.
It's convincing.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's not even that it's convincing. You just get the impression she doesn't care.
She doesn't care.
Mm. Like, you're just meat bags in her eyes.
Tulip and Tulip and Daffodil's. Tulip and Daffodil's father, does he live here too?
Nope.
Well, really? Where is he?
Dad.
He died? Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that. When did he die?
10 years ago.
Ten years ago.
May I ask how he died?
Natural causes.
No, ghost.
Is that any specific?
I'll translate. Is he a ghost?
This one.
I think that's what he said. No, not him. This the your husband. Okay. So you haven't seen or heard anything from him?
Nope.
Have you ever wanted to talk to him? Because you know, perhaps my services could be of assistance.
Nope.
You never felt the need. Never wanted to ask him a question.
Nope.
No? Okay.
He was a loser.
He was a he was a deadbeat, was he?
Yeah.
Not the happiest marriage then.
I'm pretty happy.
Okay. What?
Are you really a dino breather?
Money's coming in, wages being paid, girls got a roof over their head. They got friends to play with, it's fine.
But aren't you worried that these hauntings, perhaps, if you know, less clients come, then maybe your future won't be quite so secure?
We've had more clients than ever.
May I ask who these children's friends are? You said they had friends to play with.
Jack Will's son.
Oh, he's got a son, has he?
Jack Wills, I'm sure I've heard of him. Isn't he a tailor or something?
He's the guy who just met.
Whoops. Sorry.
Oh, he's disappeared at this point, by the way, since he's done his business. He's shuffled off somewhere.
What do you think of Jack?
Yep, all right. Pays me on time.
Pays you on time. And he's a good guy, an upstanding gentleman.
Mm-hmm.
It's a pleasure to hear.
Worries about the inn a lot.
Well, you know, there's an awful lot of pressure on a businessman, yeah. It's got to keep you employed.
Small business. That's why he called us, right? Called us because he's worried about the ghosts.
Yep.
And you do not mirror these fears that he has.
Ghosts don't bother me.
Why?
Ghosts are scary.
Why don't you ask him? You'll probably see him tonight.
Can I detect evil and good on these people?
Is that a thing?
Yeah. Can I detect evil?
Oh my god.
Do you have to do a spell thing or something?
Do a little roll. Oh, I haven't written it down.
I don't think you do for detective. I think it just happens.
Just happens. if you look in the player's handbook.
E-F-D-E.
I hope everyone's just getting the books out.
Detect evil and good.
Evil and good.
For the duration, you know if there is an aberration, celestial, elemental, fey, fiend, or undead within 30 feet of me.
Nice.
So basically, yeah.
Is there a ghost?
So you want to cast detect
evil.
Evil.
Yeah, yeah. Mm. And I suppose within 30 feet of us is like...
The whole tavern.
That's probably, yeah,
it's
the whole...
It's blocked by 1 foot of stone, 1 inch of common metal.
Or at least be in this room, okay. Then, I suppose. Yeah.
This room only
evil
then.
Good.
I can do that 4 times, and there's more than 4 rooms in this place.
I have a feeling those twins are evil. I don't think I need a spell to like, determine that. But yeah, you want to be a cleric.
I mean, they probably won't be like undead or fey or aberrations or anything, but I want to see if there's anything creepy in this room.
Yeah,
there's a lot of people in here.
Yeah, it's good.
You going to do that?
Yeah.
Okay. So you...
Wait, how does it work?
Do you have to cast it? I think it's for the duration.
Is it like a really obvious spell that you're casting?
Yeah, is it super obvious? Are you trying to hide it, or are you just like, full out?
Bam. Yeah, I'm just going to, in the middle
it's
of the
verbal tablet. And semantic, so you've got to talk and make
yeah,
gestures.
Yeah, you've got to talk and chant and stuff.
Oh, so, all right.
Immerse me.
Spooky spirits in this room. I want to see you.
Come out.
There's no rhyme at the end. It's just
So you cast your spell, and as the magic starts working, Del just still standing there, still polishing the mug.
Okay.
The girls, Tulip and Daffodil, are still staring at you.
All right.
Still staring at you. Still staring at you.
So what about the rest of the room?
Everyone in the room suddenly starts taking on that glow, that kind of phantasmal...
So I can see something's wrong with them, essentially. Everyone else,
every
all of these
patron
people.
In the room looks a bit floaty, a bit glowy, a little bit skeletal.
Okay.
Yep. And do you want to roll me a perception check as well? Anyone can do this if you want.
Cool. So, I got 17.
It's higher than mine.
12.
Okay. You two, your spell, does it only reveal to you or does it reveal to
everyone?
I'm pretty sure it only revealed to me, but
to
I
you.
Can communicate it, I suppose.
Okay. You two, as far as you're concerned, you just see him doing a bit of a chanty chant and you're just like, whatever. But what you notice, Tom,
you know.
Is that... Now that you've actually paid attention, like seen that they're kind of not this mortal realm, their clothing doesn't really quite match. Like some of them like seem to have kind of fashion of
your current era. Mm. But some of them, like their clothing looks a little bit older, like a little bit kind of like from a past era. It's not quite right. Like, but they're all just sat at their tables, just drinking and grumbling and just, you know.
And they didn't seem to care that I just...
No.
What are you mumbling about, Dupree?
Well, Mr. Kerr and Scruffy, do not panic now. I know you're prone to panicking.
Dog's glowing as well, by the way.
What?
Dog's glowing as well.
Oh, I thought you meant Doobie.
Not his dog.
Oh. Is there like a quiet corner we can go into? Or?
I mean, yeah, probably like, yeah, it's probably quite quiet there.
Okay, all right. Okay.
I'll say for the purpose of, you know, I'd ran out of minis, but there's a table.
Oh, okay.
You can kind of cluster around.
Investigator team huddle.
Okay.
Okay.
Quit eating, Scruffy.
No, he's still eating. Really close to our faces. Spitting food.
Oh, I'm just wiping it off my gnome mustache. Like,
the dog's just in the corner, though.
Got, like,
dog's,
pickling
dog's
the hair.
Yeah. Okay.
Mustard on my nose. Everywhere.
He looks like he's just sleeping, though. He's just having an old dog sleep.
Unlike first suspicions, there's something wrong with those children and Dell. It seems I have just detected that all the other patrons in this bar, there's something not quite right with them. I believe them to be ghosts themselves.
Ghosts themselves.
Ghosts! I run away out of the room.
Did you yell this as well?
Yeah, definitely. I pick up Doobie and I sprint out of the room.
What are you scaring him for?
I try to tell him to calm down.
There's no ghosts here.
You hear a little bit of a chuckle as Scruffy.
Scruffy and Doobie.
Scruffy and Doobie just run out of the room. You can just see him just go, city folk.
You mean to say all of these people are ghosts?
There's something not quite right with them. I detected evil.
And these people are evil, you're saying? You used magic to determine this, okay.
Well, if you look at their clothes, which is the only bit of information I got, by the way, it's not quite from this time.
And you start to notice as well, like, yeah.
It doesn't quite make sense.
Yeah, like, fashion-wise, like, you're a fashionable dude, you know, okay. being a famous person.
Yeah, look at his t-shirt.
You know, available on store.yogscast.com. This one wants, you know,
That one will be in 1 week.
Yeah.
Along with the new Korak HighRollers t-shirt.
Yeah. Oh.
There you go.
But nice. Yeah.
Or
the Bodega shirt.
Oh, and the Bodega shirt is available now.
Cover that up.
That's a beauty.
What was I saying? Yeah, so, you know, there are some people here who have the kind of clothing of your current time, but you're looking at everyone else and, like, yeah, there are some fashions here that are pretty old. And you being a gnome, you've
pick up
200
this.
Years, you've seen fashion
yeah,
change.
Yeah, I've seen the fashion change.
He's a forest gnome, to be fair.
Do I recognise anybody's
lives in
particular
the woods.
Not really, but you just, you get the sense that there are people from different historical periods here.
All right, cool. So, what do you think we should do? Should we start talking to them? Or do you think they're evil ghosts?
Out of interest, when we do look at them, do any of them seem to have, like, tattered clothing or, like, stab wounds or anything of the sort? Like, if they are...
How hard are you looking?
I'm looking.
6 hard.
About 9 hard.
Oh.
Yeah. Wow.
I'm currently 9
hard. You're a little bit freaked out.
Yeah. You guys can't see this, but yeah, it's impressive. Jeez.
Dick size, jeez.
Yeah, everybody roll for dick size. It's a thing we do on the show.
It's a 1!
They actually rolled.
Oh, wow.
Roll a 1! Rolled. Look.
11.
5. Is that a 1? Yeah, it's a 1.
You rolled a 1.
Generally, we rolled a 1.
Mikey's gone to the toilet.
I got a micro dick.
He's got a terrible bladder.
He just needs to check.
So you got a 1. You
got 5.
You got 5.
My name's Scruffy. I got a micro penis.
I can't believe you guys actually rolled for that. It didn't mean you to.
Of course, you were good. Anyway, so I can't see any, like...
Yeah, so it doesn't... There's no... you're so freaked out by what you've just discovered. And the girls in the corner are really freaking you out. Like... Holy God.
So far, they're the most innocent of all in this tavern.
Yeah. They're loving this, though. They're just like, they can see you guys are kind of getting a bit scared and they're just like giggling at each other.
I'm going to keep running upstairs now. I'm trying to get to my room.
Yeah. Wow, okay.
Yep.
I don't know what. Okay, I think.
The police are coming. It's great.
Shit.
I think I might go down and sit at one of the tables.
On one of the, with the ghosts?
Well, you said it and you've confirmed it now, but yeah, okay.
I mean, I don't really know how much more I had to say.
Yeah, no,
you said right. Ghosts a minute ago.
Yeah, all right, I'll sit down at one of the tables.
I think you said ghosts.
I think just to be
the
safe.
The G word! Oh, jeez!
There was only two of them.
Zoinks!
They're not saying anything, but it's hostile. They're just like...
Oh, is it?
Well, you know, if you were to go into a British pub in a small village on a Sunday night...
Right. And just sit with a random group of people.
And just sit with some random old dudes.
Yeah. Hey, what's going on here?
They're just like, they're not doing anything hostile, but their body language is like, what are you doing?
Mm. Fair, if we went and sat with any group of like people, like, they'd be like,
What are you doing, mate?
Why are you sitting with us?
What are you doing,
Geese? Well, I'll just go up to him and just be like, excuse me, we're here from the...
SIO.
SIO. And we're here investigating some strange going-ons around these taverns. This tavern. These parts, this tavern. That's what I'm going for.
You just hear a bit of a kind of grumbly, like, seafood. Not from around here.
You don't know how to harvest corn.
These people are just not giving up. All right, okay. Well...
It's very hot fuzz. I'm really getting a hot fuzz vibe from this...
No luck catching them swans, then.
It's just the one swan, actually.
No luck catching them ghosts, then. Okay, I think we just need to... Is there any other room? I suppose that's like the kitchen.
Well, you saw that this is where the guy came from with the food and stuff like that. And when the kind of door swung open, it looked like a kitchen, kitcheny stuff. Do you want me to be more aggressive?
Okay, kitchen stuff.
So exactly Tom, how many pans?
I tried to speak to them, and yeah, they just didn't care.
They're just a bit like, okay. What are you doing?
Is there any like patron who looks particularly different to the others? I know they all look. No one stands out as anything special.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. And then this is another employee.
No, I just ran out of minis.
Right, okay.
I don't suppose I can find where, what was it, Jack?
Jackwell.
Jackwell's gone.
Can you?
Could I try?
what would you like to do that?
I'll go back to Dale. Did you happen to see where Jackwell went to?
Boss keeps to himself.
Do you happen to know where I might find him?
It's coming up to, and she kind of looks around, like,
gonna look at her phone. Then.
She's gonna get out her iPhone, yeah. Available on store. She kind of like looks around, and she's like, it's coming up to after hours, so probably gone to bed.
Lock in.
It's almost time for last orders, so.
Does he have a room in this tavern that I could potentially find him?
Of course, he lives here.
Do you happen to know which room?
She's so annoying.
Oh, do you ever leave this room? You don't know.
I just don't like telling things to someone who's a stranger. I mean, this is my place of employment, and I do live here with Daffodil and Tulip, yes.
Right.
I don't want to tell a strange man where my room is.
I don't need to know your room.
What happens if I get ravished at night?
I'm not in the business of ravishing. You must know what room Jackwell is from. I mean, come on. Up. I'm going to go up.
Speaking of up, I...
Yeah, okay, so
get
you...
to number two.
Hold on.
All right,
we
reveal
can
the
reveal
area first.
The very well-drawn map. Oh, there's a lot more paper here than I thought. That's probably been, yeah. Oh, look at how wonderfully it's been drawn.
Oh my god. Which one's number two?
So you've run all the way up here. So you run up these kind of creaky, musty old stairs. Are you paying attention to anything as you run up?
Oh, I'm just running. I'm looking for the number two.
You're just freaking out.
I want to get to my room and hide.
Yeah, okay, it's this room here.
I get my key out and I fumble it and I drop it and I pick it up.
Bang your head against the door a little bit. And then I
go inside and I slam the door and lock it.
Yeah.
And then just
cower
in the corner. Okay. And I look for, is there a bathroom in here? Ensuite?
Allow me to describe it to you. Allow me to set the scene for you, Duncan.
Okay.
Okay, so yeah, you've gone into the room. And now that you've sort of starting to kind of look around and pay attention to what's going on, it's a very poorly lit room, really dusty. You can kind of see the dust floating around in the air. And the air as well smells a bit stale and a bit like socks. Bad socks, not good socks.
Is that you, Doobie?
The walls.
I love the smell of good socks.
The walls are kind of, you know, padded halfway up with a cracked, with like cracked peeling burgundy leather. And then the white walls above it, they're peeling as well. Like, again, everything just seems to be a little bit run down, a little bit disrepair. The mattress, the bed looks a bit gross. Like, it's a straw mattress. And there's a sink in the corner of the room that just seems to be dripping green water.
Green?
Yeah, it's a bit gross.
Gross.
And the kind of the enamel.
That's explained. Like let's go home, guys.
What enamel?
They're just food poisoning. That's all it is.
And the sink itself is a bit cracked and stained. Okay. Like it's all a bit. It's, a bit, yeah. It's a bit like, you know, when you stay in that travel lodge and it's a bit.
Right.
So do you remember when we went to Res to Eurogamer in London,
God,
and we stayed
called?
At that hotel that was just a disaster, and all the
it was
blinds
like the,
were ripped
up. What was it called?
Up.
Like the Soho Hotel or something
like that. And it was everyone had something really fucked up
awful.
In their room, like cracked lamps and windows.
It looked like a bear had been in my room and just smashed everything.
Yeah, and it was yeah.
The lampshade was like torn up. Like,
yeah, it was the worst.
The shade, yeah. Like, what are they called? The blinds. Were,
like, mine was like hanging off
and
wall,
like
yeah.
broken.
Since I've managed events, has this ever happened, guys?
No, there we go. Yeah, it has been pretty good. It's not been as bad as that hotel we stayed at. Jesus Christ. Yeah.
So it's like that. Okay, I got it. That's a good picture in my mind.
Yeah, there you
I'm
go.
In that room now.
Okay. What are you doing?
Is there a toilet? No toilet.
Nope.
Just a sink.
Just a sink.
We're in ye olde times.
I might have to pee in the sink then.
Just a hole.
Think then, mind if I pee in the sink?
Go ahead. Go for it. Make a roll. Make a roll to hit.
Who's the DM here?
So I need to pee pretty bad after that beer, and like I'm pretty scared, so I need to pee. I want to pee in the sink.
Okay.
Do I have to roll?
Do you need the DM's permission to pee in the sink?
No.
Pee
what happened? I'm peeing in the sink.
Okay.
I whip out my micro penis.
What did you get for penis size?
An 11.
Okay.
At plus 6.
No, we don't add.
How
pluses.
Big is that in inches?
I don't know. Ask Mark when he gets back.
It's about average, isn't it? 11. Is that literally average?
What, an 11-inch penis? Is,
no, no, on the
D20. Oh my God!
All right, the character of this show has really gone down since Mark's been away.
11 is the average roll of a D20.
So you're peeing in
zero.
The sink, Duncan.
I thought you meant. Yeah. Okay.
Duncan.
I'm peeing in the sink. That's happening. What? Anything happen? No. Doobie's like turned away. Cocks his leg against the bedpost.
Oh God, really?
Well, I can't stop him, he's a dog.
He's a wolf, but...
He's a wolf dog.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Anything else?
That's it.
No? I'm okay. Done. Back to hide. You two, what are you two doing?
Okay, so I want to wander over to these a different group of patrons, mm-hmm. but I just want to try my luck at talking to them. So I introduce myself to one of them, or to all three of them, I say, hi. So you've probably already heard of me. I'm Mr. Kerr, the famous seance mystic guy. Perhaps
mystic.
Do any of you ever, have any of you ever tried speaking to the dead? So raise my eyebrow. Like, is there any? Do I get to any of them make a weird reaction on his?
You just get a bit of a chuckle, like a kind of like
bit of a chuckle.
Like you're an idiot.
You're an idiot. No, seriously, I'm very good for it. Perhaps if any of you have any. Siblings, relations, ex-girlfriends, anything, anybody you could possibly want to talk to, ask a question to.
One of them who's a human, big, portly, old, mutton chops, you know, white hair, just kind of leans forward and goes, you're not from round here, are you, sick pig?
How can you tell?
Because you're asking dumb questions, innit?
Why is this question so dumb?
you think about it.
Yeah.
You don't know what you're getting yourself in for, do you, boy?
What am I getting myself into?
And he just goes back to his job, like rolls his eyes. City folk,
yeah. Okay.
And you can hear the two twins behind you just kind of giggling, like they heard what you said and they're just giggling, like they are so thoroughly amused by this.
Yeah. Okay. What are you up to, Dupree?
I think I would like to.
Do we want to have a little chat? A quiet chat.
Well, we haven't found anything out since we last had a quiet chat.
Okay. Meanwhile, Del is going to ding the bell behind the bar. Last orders.
Does anyone react to that?
Yeah, you hear a kind of like a... But yeah.
Do you fancy another drink, Dupree?
I mean, I'm tempted to see if we stay in here, whether they will leave. Like...
Just vanish.
That's the thing, like...
Yeah.
There's something not right with them.
No, certainly.
I don't think they're just going to go up to their room. Hang on a minute. How many rooms are there in this tavern?
Eight. 9.
And they're all staying in these rooms, including her room and Jackwell's room.
There's another stairs here. There might be
another
floor.
Do you know how many floors there are?
Oh, I suppose. You
know? There could be
well,
more floors.
Well, you two don't know this because you haven't been upstairs yet. He doesn't really technically know this because he's only just run into his room in a blind panic. So retcon that.
Right. Okay. We can't see how many floors there were from entering the place.
Were you paying attention?
Probably not.
There you go.
Cool.
But I mean, you know,
you could probably tell if it was more than one floor.
It's a fairly typical inn.
Yeah, yeah.
You know,
there's a lot of windows.
Just because they're drinking here doesn't necessarily mean that they're staying here. Because it is you know, one of these old travelling inns where it is a pub as well as lodging.
Yeah.
Actually, I think I might go back into this room and ring the bell again. Because I imagine like people come in all the time looking for lodging.
It's quite late in the night right now.
Mm.
Last orders about 11
so
o'clock.
They wouldn't let anyone in after a certain time.
Mm.
I think I'll try it anyway.
Yeah.
Just ring the bell. Yeah.
Ring that
ding, ding, ding.
Ding, ding.
Tang.
So you ring the bell.
Mm-hmm.
And you can kind of like, you know, you wait.
Okay.
And you wait.
Yeah.
And you can hear a faint sound coming down the stairs to your left there.
Mm.
And it's the sound of heavy feet slowly coming down the stairs.
But?
Can't see anything.
Ooh.
Jesus.
I mean...
I think I'm giving up on my conversation. I'm coming in at the same time. What's that knocking?
So you just walked out of the bar?
Yeah.
Okay. You just hear the girls giggling behind you. You're all gonna die!
Jesus Christ.
Right. Mr. Kerr, I believe there may be something in this room with us now.
No, trust me, I'm very perceptive. I can't see anything. Then I make a perception check. I get an 11. Nope.
It's a bit cold. But, you know, might be because it was snowing outside, don't know.
Yeah, it's chilly. It's
snowing outside.
I can't tell if it's just because it's snowing outside or if perhaps there's some otherworldly presence in this room with us. But yes, it's just definitely there's at least a draft in here.
It's a bit drafty in here. Yeah.
I mean, the doors are closed, the windows are closed. There's a fire in the corner, it's in the other room.
You remember you got your room keys as well, you know. And who took the keys?
I've got the keys.
Yeah, and you've got your also. Where's the shaggy one?
Scruffy.
Yeah.
I saw him run.
He's been gone for a while now.
He always does that. He's easily scared. Can we just since it's empty? Can I just like have a little poke around and like maybe look in here?
I was going to say that.
Door is locked.
I'd not remove the longer set of keys and try to open the door.
Yeah, so after a little go, one of them pops it open. Yeah, you go in. It's an office, so you can see like there's kind of a little table and a chair, a sort of desk and a chair. Lots of paperwork everywhere.
So, yeah. Any like...
Steve, I just looked at the screen and they were up
there.
Oh my God! Nice.
Oh.
that's freaked me out.
Holy water.
Oh my god, it's even worse. There's Duncan and Tom behind them.
It was us.
Yeah. I'm looking around. So is there like an accounts book maybe? Or like an important looking ledger? Like finances? I don't know.
Well, there is a ledger that is the guest ledger.
Yeah. Went missing.
Huh?
I thought that went missing.
I guess not.
I guess not. Okay.
You're so naive, Tom. You do believe everything everyone tells you.
I trusted this guy. Why?
The guest ledger. But you know, you kind of look through it and you just see names and dates, and it kind of matches up to what he told you.
So, and like recently, there's names there. Mm-hmm. People are definitely going in.
There definitely seems to be a lot more names in the last couple of months than there have been. Like earlier in the year, earlier in the previous year and stuff like that.
How far does it date back, this ledger?
That one would probably date back to probably about 2 years.
Okay.
But yeah, there's definitely, you can see that it wasn't that busy. There's not that many names kind of 2 years back, but then in the recent months, there's been a lot of business.
This is, wait, in 2 months, that was when the first person went missing?
2 weeks.
2 weeks.
Can we look to 2 weeks ago?
That was when the second person died.
I
think 2 weeks ago was when the first one died. 1 week ago was when the second one died.
They might have gone missing before that.
So I guess it's when they found the body.
But I mean, like, because other people gone missing other than died.
Can we check, actually, can we see around like 2 to 3 weeks ago, can we see if any of the people were staying in room 2, 3, or 7?
Mm-hmm. The person who went missing 2 weeks ago, room 2, 1 week ago, room, let me consult my note, 7.
Right.
And, there were only 2 people, yeah.
Great, so room 3, the one I'm staying in.
Nothing out of the ordinary.
That's the next one then.
Mm. Yeah.
That's Kench.
Yeah.
All right.
You guys,
I think,
cool. Anything else
in there? Are there any draws? I just have a good rifle round, make a perception check. 10.
So you rifle around. It just seems to be papers about business.
Can I also do the same perception check as well? Okay, I got perception 16.
Okay. So you just see kind of just general business in stuff in it, you know, like kind of invoices
boring,
for the beer, a kind of maid's fee, that kind of thing, invoices to Dell.
Come on, Dupree, let's go. This place is worthless. There's nothing else here.
And Dupree, you kind of notice that there are...
Oh, hold on a second.
I'm very perceptive, I can assure you.
You notice
but
that there
here,
are
I've just found.
A couple of kind of like... So I didn't manage to clear this up with Marcus to whether or not this would exist in his world, but I guess like kind of like local news paper, just like literally a sheet, handwritten. There are articles about haunting at Overlook Inn, you know, and they're all kind of quite campy in the way they're written, quite excited, you know, quite like, ooh, there's spooky goings on kind of thing. Almost kind of like an advert, you know, but it's definitely making it sort of like really like, ooh, come down for mischief and adventure, like, you know, will you see the spooky ghost?
Yeah, is it the same author of all of these articles?
So everything's written in the same handwriting.
Yeah.
The handwriting does not match the handwriting of most of the, like the invoices and all that.
Okay. And it doesn't say who the author is in that case.
The author is just, it's not Jack Wills.
Okay. I was just going to see if it matched anyone in the ledger to see if they stayed here. Okay.
No.
Can I look around my room for hidden trapdoors, hidden entrances, like wires?
Have you got any spells or anything? Or like, are you just going to do a straight up perception?
Have you got like a find traps or?
I don't think so. I've got locate object.
Well, you have to
think of a specific object.
No, I will just look around using perception.
Mm-hmm.
Perception. Wisdom. I got a 13.
13?
Hmm.
You look around, it's pretty dusty, makes you sneeze a bit. But yeah, it doesn't seem to be anything going
on. Can Doobie also look?
Yeah.
He's got to have much higher.
Dog senses activate.
He gets a 6.
It's dog.
No food here.
Just thinking about food, humping things.
So. I think. I think we should go upstairs and
yeah,
resign ourselves to the rooms.
Yeah, well, I'll come out at the same time as they come up then.
Okay, you guys coming upstairs?
I'm actually pretty hungry. I might see if maybe I can go get a snack from the kitchen really quickly. I'll see you upstairs.
Fine, I'll head upstairs.
Shortly.
Okay, you go upstairs. So you're going through that door there.
Yeah.
It's locked.
Does the key work?
Yeah.
Well, that was interesting.
So you walk through the first room. So this is like a big room here, and you can see the door here.
Yeah.
And it looks like a bedroom. It looks like a bedroom where two young girls, there's two small kind of cots in the kind of American sense of the word, you know, like little beds. Oh. And there is a bigger bed in the other corner. A general mess.
I'm terrified immediately upon thinking who might lodge in this room. I just want to give it like a quick scan around, perception, particularly actually this thing, this big bookcase right here. I'm going to look at that with my 19.
That can't be important.
I'm drawn to it for some reason.
Okay. I mean, it's literally just a mini I had in the box.
Oh really? Ah, okay, it's not the haunted.
So you look around and what you see is the rooms, especially where the girls, the little beds are, it's a mess. Like, it's just clothes everywhere and just like toys strewn over all over the floor. Mm. The kind of bigger bed area is a little bit more ordered, but you can tell it's just, you know, it's a living
space.
When you look behind the dresser, you can kind of see there's some like hand-drawn like drawings that have just kind of fallen. Like, there's just a mess of kids, like, you know, Crayola doesn't exist in this world. But like drawings and stuff like that.
I reach in and like I rifle through the drawings, looking at what's on them.
Yeah. So it's a lot of like normal kids stuff, like flowers and like
no pentagrams.
The house. No pentagrams.
You know how every kid. He hasn't got a head.
You know how every kid.
One of people trying to escape. There's fire.
Yeah. Or the big black circle or something like that. You know how every kid just draws a house that always looks like the same house, even though they live like, you know. Yeah, so there's that.
Okay.
You see in the house picture, you see kind of like, you know, two little girls, a little boy, and a little bear.
Oh, little boy and little bear.
Oh, that could be Jack Will's son.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Because that's who he plays. Actually, I mean, I can't think.
Jack Will's son or Jack Wilson?
Jack Will.
Jack. The brand new character from brand new family.
Okay. All right, nice. And then I decided that actually I'm not as hungry as I thought I was. And I'm going to just head upstairs.
Yeah.
All right, so I suppose I would have gone up.
So you're room three, aren't you?
Yeah, I see you.
I'm sort of not walking up particularly far, so I guess I'll get my passive perception as I'm going up.
Yeah.
So, do I see anything out of the ordinary?
Didn't see anything out of the ordinary, but you hit, like, as soon as you got to like the top of the stairs, you felt really cold. Hmm. Like, just, and it was kind of like a cold draft, just kind of like kind of just washed through you.
Right. What room is this? Is this number one, I guess?
If you're actively looking at it, you can see it's a toilet. There's just a curtain. There's not a door. It's just a curtain, and it's you know, one of them old fashioned toilets where it's like a wooden bench with a hole and a pit.
Nice.
On the first
floor.
Nice.
Well, you can see there's a basin under the thing.
All right. Okay,
pull
nice.
It out. Retcon.
Well, while I'm on this floor, once I feel that cold. I want to hold my holy symbol of Paylor. I want to hold my holy book, and I want to just sort of declare out into the room, if there's any spirits here, please make yourself known.
I'm no spirit. What are you talking about, Dupree?
I hear walking up the stairs, and I'm like...
Yeah, you're getting ready. Yeah.
Next you'll be trying to do my job. Leave it to the professionals, okay? Yeah. Go back to your
bag. I got a spirit right here.
And while that happens, and you get creeped out by your companions like that, you do hear a kind of like a little chuckle, and like you just feel that little, like, you know, kind of the hairs on the back of your neck just stick up a little bit.
Yeah.
And you're just kind of like
kind of feeling you out.
You're not really sure if that happened because, you know, you're being distracted by these two, but something doesn't feel right. But then it's gone.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm just gonna. I guess head down to my room, which I guess.
Okay, so it's room two, room three, and I don't know where my notepad went, so.
It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Yeah, there you go.
Okay.
So that's your room, Duncan, and that's Mikey's room.
As I walk past, I just say, Scruffy. Scruffy.
Scruffy.
Everybody is
Scruffy.
Very weird downstairs.
Are they all ghosts?
Yes, I'm pretty sure. I think they might be ghosts or some sort of apparition. I don't know. They all seem to be, I don't know, they're certainly not normal. They're certainly not.
Oh, jeez. Zoinks.
Zoinks. But yes, I guess we're going to bed now.
I don't want to sleep in there. Wow. It's gross. There's piss in the sink.
There's piss in the sink. How on earth did that get there? Should we have cleaned that up?
I don't know. Blame Doby. Or me! I pissed on the bed! Oh, jeez, Doby. On the bed?
He's just having a conversation with himself. The wolf is kind of like barking stuff, but you're just watching this man have a conversation with his wolf.
Okay, well, I'll see you in the morning for breakfast, I hope.
Okay, so you're going to go into that one, yeah. You're going to go back into...
No, I'm going to go explore him.
You're going to go exploring?
Yeah.
Okay. So yeah, on that note, we will take a short break. 5 minutes. 5 minutes. Yeah. Quick pee break.
See you soon.
And yeah, we'll see you in a minute.
Spoopy.
For more.
Too much.
Spoops.
Goodbye.
2 spoops for me.
Do we still do stuff for the subscribers? With Scrubbers?
Thank you.
Just like how all of you did that, and I was going to be like, serious intro. Hello and welcome back to High Rollers. We are doing a horror one shot because most of the crew are off being wizards and fields. Just a quick little catch up. So the Supernatural Squad, or someone has suggested the name Association of Abnormal Apparition Hunters.
Yeah,
or that's
fantastic.
They have arrived at the Overlook Inn, where the kind of rather nervous owner, Jackwill, kind of explained that there's been some disappearances, there's been some deaths, you know, please help. They went to hang out in the bar, where our resident priest discovered that pretty much everyone in that bar was undead.
Except
the
creepy twins.
The creepy twins.
And the halfling.
Mum. Barkeeper.
Ate an enormous sandwich.
Yep.
Yeah.
I discovered I had a micropenis.
Yep. Emotional times.
Yeah. We're all devastated by that news, Duncan.
We also found out that the children, the twins, play with Jack Will's son.
Jack Wilson. That's his name, that's fantastic.
No, it's not!
And there are some strange drawings from them that...
Just kids' drawings.
No, they're creepy.
That
sounds like a normal kids' drawing.
You two technically haven't seen it. He's seen it. Yeah. Whether or not he just tells you.
What was on the drawing again? So it's a little boy and a little bear.
Little teddy bear.
Playing with the twins.
And the house.
And just generic.
Yeah. That honestly sounds like pretty tame for kids, honestly. When I was a kid, I used to draw like train crashes.
Wow.
So it's getting up to midnight. We're going to move swiftly away from that. It's getting up to midnight and...
I'm not kidding.
Come on, man, you're derailing the conversation.
That's good.
So Dupree and Kerr have gone to their rooms, and you are roaming corridors.
I didn't like my room, so I'm just going to sneak along here and I'm gonna carry Doobie.
You're going to carry... Is he like resisting this, or is he?
No, he's loving it.
Yeah.
He doesn't like walking much.
Isn't he like as big as you?
I'm pretty strong.
Okay, but he's just like this giant wolf, just being carried around.
When you run, do you sort of run on the spot for a bit before you dash off?
Well, I'm not running. I'm sneaking.
Oh, okay.
I'm gonna roll a stealth check actually.
Okay.
That's a 19.
Okay. Yeah, you're pretty stealthy. You're like, I'd like to imagine that in your head, you're like going.
Do-do-do-do-do.
Yeah. I mean, the corridor's pretty dark, it's pretty gloomy. That really awful carpet is still here as well, you know, with all the geometric shapes. It makes you a little bit dizzy.
It doesn't show dirt, though.
Yeah.
Well, that's why they do them.
It's a little bit sticky, though. Okay, so you get down to the end of the corridor.
I'm gonna go up the stairs.
You're going to go up the stairs? Yeah. Okay, how far are you looking? Like, you looking up the stairs, you looking at your feet? Wait.
I'm looking at the top of the stairs.
Okay. Oh, you're not going to like this. So you look at the top of the stairs.
Oh, no.
And the twins are there.
Hi.
And they're like, Do you want to play, mister?
Oh, Jesus.
They're back.
That's them at the top of the stairs.
Do you want to play with us forever and ever and ever
No. Doobs, let's get out of here!
Really?
I'm going to run back to my room.
Okay.
Slam the door and lock it.
Okay. Fine.
Yeah,
okay.
All right.
Yeah. In the meantime, who shall we go to first? Mike.
Hello.
What are you doing in your room? So you're in your room. Pretty much same as Duncan's room, like pretty much identical.
Horrible stuff.
Yeah, it's pretty run down, pretty gross.
I mean, I had a lot of beers.
The mattress, the bed, however, has a really dark stain on the mattress.
Red stain or?
Just a really dark
Just dark.
Yeah, it's quite dark in the rooms. So, like, there's just a very like kind of basic oil lamp burning away in the corner, so it's just really
easy. Take the lamp and I investigate the stain closely. Is this like a blood pool? Like, I'm a rogue. I know what blood looks like.
Yeah, you know.
Is this a blood stain or is it something else?
It's an old blood stain. It smells irony.
Oh, are there like stab marks in the mattress as well, or is it just blood?
It's just blood.
Oh, okay. I'm disgusted. Yeah. This is absolutely vile. I put the lamp back on the thing.
Yeah.
I go over to the sink.
Okay.
Brush my teeth.
You're gonna brush your teeth?
Yeah. Of course I.
In the green water.
Yeah, with the green water. Okay. I'm not disgusting.
Is it green water in his room too?
Yeah, it's a bit. So you. I guess to brush your teeth, do we have toothbrushes in this?
I carry a toothbrush, yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Got a feather.
It's sort of like a... Yeah.
I guess, or do you even just like brush it on your finger?
It's like pig hair in a stick, and I put some sort of stuff on there and I brush my teeth.
That's baking the most soda. Horrific thing
baking so far. Soda, yeah, classic. Yeah.
Lime. Okay.
Do that.
Wow. So you turn the tap on.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it takes a little time for the... You can hear the pipes are creaking, they're like, you know, really, really creaky. And like this kind of dark green, like slightly stinky water starts kind of dripping.
Oh, God.
Dripping. And then you just hear a bloop. And yeah, just something really dark just falls out of the tap into the sink.
Can I use like an insight check? On this,
Or
I just look at it. Like, what is it? So it's.
What do you put your?
I need to know what history.
I smell it.
Yeah. Do you put your face down?
I put my face down.
Yeah.
I.
You're pretty sure it's hair.
Oh. Hair came out of the tap.
A big lump of matted hair.
And do I like recognize the animal the hair might have come from?
I would say that's an insight. Yeah.
Yeah. That will be a nature, 8, be a 15.
Be nature? Well, we'll say that's a nature.
We'll do a nature, it's a 17.
So you don't recognise it as any animal, but you're pretty sure it's human.
This actually, funnily enough, reminds me of cleaning Duncan's flat.
I do shed a lot.
So human hair has just come out the sink. Okay, I actually stopped brushing my teeth now because this is creeping me out a bit. Can I just do a quick investigation of the rest of the room? Mm-hmm. Are there like toenails and drawers or like any other human?
Well, are you gonna be like?
Oh, I'm disgusted. I'm like literally. I thought this place was bad, but I didn't realize it was this bad. This is repulsive.
Well, as you stand up and look, there's a big kind of burnished mirror on the wall, like in front of the sink.
Mm.
And roll me a perception check.
A 9.
Okay. You're not entirely sure, but you think something just moved out of the corner of your eye in the mirror.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
So I turn around to what would be behind me. There's nothing there.
Nothing.
I turn around, back around and look in the mirror again.
Okay, roll me another perception.
This would be an 8.
Nothing
is there. I can't hear anything, I can't smell anything. And does it feel cold? Has that got that familiar?
Well, now that you're thinking about it, it is a bit chilly in here.
Okay. So I go over to the window to make sure it's closed.
Just single glaze, isn't it?
Yeah, the window's... Wooden shutters.
Wooden shutters.
Iron bars.
Iron bars. Is there like a reflection? There's no glass. Is there a reflection
no
of anything in the glass
anything.
Behind
no,
me?
No.
Okay. I'm really fucking freaked out.
Mm-hmm. I would like you to... Yes.
Okay.
I'm just going to get my dungeon master's menu.
Oh, no, I don't like this.
Could you please roll me a straight up d20?
Yep.
And what I'm making you roll for is I'm making you roll a sanity check.
A sanity check?
Oh, shit.
Okay. All right. I rolled a 7.
Yeah, okay. So, given who you are.
Yep.
And, in case, are you a believer in the supernatural?
No, I claim that I can speak to ghosts, mm-hmm. but I'm adamant that they don't exist.
Okay.
And there's nothing of the sort.
In it for the money.
And
yeah,
things,
I'm in it for the money.
Things are starting to happen. like the hair.
The hair, the coldness.
The stain on the,
Yeah.
You're really so far out of your comfort zone. And it feels wrong. Like the atmosphere in the room feels wrong. Like, the hair is standing up on the back of your neck and like you got goosebumps and
I'm panicking. I have no idea what's going on.
So, do you have percentile dice?
Yes.
Do you have 2 of them? Yeah. I need you to roll for me.
Yeah.
and tell me what percentage you've got.
You are 80% insane.
I got a 49.
Okay. okay, so you are now suffering from short-term madness.
Short-term madness, okay.
Yeah.
That could be worse.
Could be long-term.
It's gonna last 20 minutes.
20 minutes, okay. Mm-hmm.
And during this period of time, you rolled a 49, right?
Yep.
The character begins babbling and is incapable of normal speech or spell casting. So for 20 minutes,
blah, blah,
you're just like, blah,
yeah. Like scraping at the walls, like, looking for the door, and I can't fucking find it. I'm
so you're just, yeah,
trying to yell, but even that,
you've just
I can't
lost
do.
It. Yeah,
I've
you're just
it.
Like, just a gibbering wreck. And
gibbering
you can't,
wreck.
Yeah, if
okay.
anyone comes to talk to you, you can't. Blah, and you can't cast any spells, you can't do anything. So that's going to last 20
minutes. 20 minutes, okay, fantastic.
Okay. Going to leave you there. Just kind of wetting yourself a little bit.
I don't suppose I can hear that. Or is that happening meanwhile to what I'm doing?
This is while you're looking around your room. So again, exactly the same kind of room. No dark stain on your one.
So I'm just holding my symbol, my holy symbol and the holy book as I walk in. Mm-hmm. Just going to roll just like a perception just for around the room. Is that Well, perception 19.
Okay. nothing, it's pretty crappy in here. Like, you know, you're not really sure. Like, if you had to have paid the money to stay here, and if TripAdvisor existed in this world, you're already composing like the crappy review in your head. Like, it's really run down, it's a bit dusty, it smells gross. Like, it just smells a bit like sour, and yeah, it's just, you know, but there's nothing out of the ordinary. At best, all you spot is that the bed sheets are a bit ruffled and a bit like, you know, like someone sat on the bed or like tussled up, but it could just be that they hadn't properly cleaned up the room.
Yeah, this is the only room where, based on the ledger, like, no one has gone missing from yet, though. Right, I guess I'll investigate bathroom, like turn on the taps, look in the mirror, like.
Yeah, I mean the water's green. A bit green, but yeah, it works fine. You know, it takes a little bit to get started and come up through the pipes, but it's fine.
I mean, if all seems well, I guess.
So I guess as you're just standing there, just in the middle room, kind of just going like,
Yeah, if I can't really feel anything, I can't really, like, see or hear anything, or nothing's out of the ordinary, really.
Where are you standing in the room?
So, I guess, wherever the, like, the sink was, I guess I'm just sort of near there, I guess right in front of the mirror, maybe.
Like, there, in that corner of the room.
Okay.
So you're kind of just washing your face, well, as best you can, and just kind of like, okay. And then you start to hear from the window a kind of a, and it's kind of like a half scratch and a half kind of like knock.
Right.
And it sounds a bit flappy as well.
A bit flappy, okay. Well, I guess I'll just go towards the window and look out, see what it could be. I'm just gonna assume it's like a bird or something, but like.
So you open the window?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah? Yeah. Okay, it's the same as in Mike's room. It's wooden shutters, iron bars. So you open the window and smack bang into your face, this kind of furry thing, wing. You can feel wings and claws and it just smacks you right in the face.
Right.
And just flaps past.
It's in my room though.
Yeah.
Can I see where it's gone?
Turn around and actually give me a little dexterity saving throw.
Dexterity? Yeah. Saving throw?
Yeah.
five.
Five.
You're so tiny.
okay, so as it kind of bam right into your face and like flailed a little bit, it scratched your eye and you're just like, ow! Like, you know, and it's not serious injury, but you can feel like a little bit of blood coming down over your eye. If you're gonna turn around and make a perception check, you have disadvantage.
I have disadvantage?
Mm-hmm. Because you've got blood in your eye.
Okay, I got perception. I got 14 then.
Okay. Yeah, as you turn around, you can hear this thing flapping like, and kind of like.
Sorry, what's the noise in
there? it's kind of squeaking a little bit like, and you can sort of see this little shape just flitting, and it's in a bit of a panic. It's a bit like the way it's moving is a little bit like randomly and like.
Right. Okay. I want to try and like herd it almost to go back out the window. Like I'm sort of waving in the air to try and get it to move away from me. And I'm trying to get it back out the window, like.
And how you're just doing that with your hands?
Yeah, just waving, like trying to sort of swish out of the air. I guess not necessarily trying to hit it, but like you know.
Mm. I would say it's not really effective. It's kind of, you know, it's up in the corners of the ceiling, and it's not really doing a great deal.
It's not come to rest anywhere.
Yeah. It's kind of like it's going by the door. It looks like it's trying to look at you, like trying to kind of like.
Right. Could I try and swat it out of the air?
You could.
I mean, I'm not sure what to do with this thing. I can't get out of the window. I could open the door, but like, I don't really want it free in the. Is there something like? Do I think it's just a bird? Do it? Or?
Well, you got blood dripping out your eye or anything? Do you want to like, you know, wipe that out or like, you know?
Yeah, I'll wipe the blood. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, you can see it's a bat.
A bat. Okay.
A little furry bat. In fact, roll me a perception check.
Oh, good. Whoa. That is for 12.
Yeah, it's a bat.
It's a bat.
It's a vampire.
Can I just look at it again and just keep looking at it until, I mean, it's in the room.
Are you going to try and swat it or anything like that?
Yes.
You got your book, haven't you? Can you like...
It's my holy book, though. Okay. Oh, actually, hang on. I do have...
I've got two.
I mean, are vampires a thing in this world? Like,
Duncan, shut up.
I'm gonna.
I don't know. I actually don't know.
Yeah, I'm gonna hit it with my holy book,
Mm-hmm.
Not just an ordinary book.
Mm-hmm.
It's holy.
Okay. Make me. What do you normally attack with? You normally attack with like spells and.
Yeah, I've got a mace, but I don't want to swing a mace in this room.
Which ping you back in the face.
Leave dents in the walls.
Give me.
Oh, that's a morning star. Mace is just a ball and a stick.
Honk. I guess a dex? Yeah, probably just a straight up dex.
Okay. Whoa, five.
Five? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so you throw your
I was just going to like two-handed, just like swinging.
Oh, you're going to swing it?
I guess it slips out of my hand, okay. Yeah.
Okay, as you swing it, you know, your hands are covered in blood, it's a bit like that.
Oh, yeah.
And then it just like poof. And yeah, it kind of like, you just hear this like as it doesn't hit the bat, but the bat's kind of like yeah.
Right.
Yeah, it just flumps to the floor, your book. Drops to the floor. At which point, I'm going to say, yeah, it kind of squeaks, and then yeah, as the book drops to the floor, this kind of poof, cloud of smoke appears, white fog, and as the fog clears, you see a man standing in your room.
Oh my god.
Dressed quite properly, you know, and he's just like, he's just standing there and he's just like.
I've had to suck your blood.
Okay, so he's in as much shock as I am.
Yeah, he's definitely a bit like.
Okay, well, I'm just going to hold my symbol up, as always, and just like, what manner of beast is this?
Beast? You are the beast. You throw your book at me. I'm Sverrier.
I am Swedish Empire.
I am Swedish Empire.
With respect, you did fly into my face.
Well, you are in my room. I'm still Swedish.
This is your room.
We're going to roll with this.
I bought the key for this room. This is my room for the night.
No, this is my room. Which room is this? My room.
It's room number...
Three.
And for the night, it is mine.
One room. Oh, curses. I'm in the wrong room. Sorry.
Before you leave, what exactly are you?
You mean you don't know? I'm still Swedish.
I mean, I haven't had a vampire bat hit me in the face and then transform into a, might I say, well-dressed man.
You just said vampire.
I haven't had a bat hit me in the face.
You're retconning that.
Retconning.
Okay.
Could be a druid.
That's true.
I am Vlad.
Vlad.
I am Vlad.
It's really hard to say that in a different accent.
I am Vlad Helleran. Hello. Yes.
What?
I am a vampire.
I mean.
And he just gives you a grin, and you can see these two fangs. Just like these really long fangs, just canines, just like gleaming away.
And how long has this been your room?
A couple nights.
I mean, what do I do?
Excuse me, young man, I can't help but notice you are bleeding. The blood.
Oh, I'm going to cover that up like straight away. Yeah. Like, oh, no.
He's just sniffing a little bit, like.
We are, me and my group of friends,
yes.
We're here to investigate some paranormal activity and...
Oh, the ghosts!
And potentially the vampires, yes?
Come now, you racist!
I apologize, I mean no slight against you. Have you seen or heard anything out of the ordinary while you've been staying here?
Oh yes, plenty.
Would you like to explain?
You are a nice man.
Thank you.
What's this symbol, this holy thing?
Oh, this symbol, I'm going to hold it like right up in his face.
He doesn't seem bothered.
This is the holy symbol of Paylor.
He's nice. He kind of reaches out and takes it. He's like, it's a nice symbol.
Oh,
it's good shape.
Thank
you. Kind of looks at it, passes it back. He's nice. Yes, there's lots of creepy things. Well, creepy to you. Not that you, unless you're children of the night.
Like you.
Like me.
I like this guy.
Yeah, he's fantastic. Yeah.
You guys don't know it. You got here. You're freaking out. You're like running into your room.
I'm trying to clean the piss out of my sink.
Piss out your pants.
Listen, Vlad, was it?
Vlad. Well, Elan, at your service.
I'm afraid I purchased a key for this room, so... And was told that this was one of the rooms in which many hauntings have taken place, so...
Oh, yes. Can you not see now?
See what? Oh.
The ghost.
Where?
In the corner.
Can't say I can.
Oh. You humans, huh? Must be so bad not being able to see things. Oh, he's gone now.
Oh, he's gone. Is he okay?
Oh, no, he's back.
He's back.
Oh, I'm joking with you.
Oh,
humans. So easy.
You know how to get me, Vlad.
No, but seriously, why are you staying in this place?
Well, we are here from the Association of Abnormal Apparitions Hunters, or something like that. for short. And we're here to investigate some paranormal activity that's been going on around this hotel. It seems if you're able to see these ghosts, you might actually be of use to us.
Yes, but I'm busy.
How busy?
I must feast.
On?
It's a B word. And he's kind of pointing at, yeah.
Right, wait, I'm gonna just try and rub that off. Like, I'm getting rid of that.
Bolognese.
Tasty, no?
I mean, I don't know where to stay. I purchased a key for this room, so either you leave or I leave.
Look, young man, I understand. My accent has gone very weird. Hold a minute. I want to suck your blood. Okay, back in the room.
He didn't say that out loud, did he? I want to leave the room.
I understand. I'm in the wrong room.
This is bad of me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry. You're bleeding. I will give you a gift. I don't know where my voice is going right now. Because I feel bad for you. Oh. And he's kind of like, he's got your hand now, and he's kind of stroking it. So young. So young.
Right, can I make a dexterity saving throw or something?
Yeah, you can.
Just to get
I mean, he's not
it...
like grabbing you, he's just like being overly friendly.
I feel like I know what the gift is.
Like...
what is it?
Well, if you're gonna be a big racist, like, you know,
can
judging
I
people.
Ask, Vlad, this gift of yours, does it have something to do with immortality?
No.
Huh. Carry on.
Say no
well,
to that.
It might be to do with your mortality, because, you know, I don't think you're going to live long.
What makes you say that, Vlad?
I've been here a few nights. I've seen the creatures in the dark walking the halls. I heard the laughs from upstairs. Oh, the laughs.
Upstairs, okay.
Yes. Quite chilling, no?
It's quite cold, yeah. Mm. Oh, chilling, yeah.
You're going to need a lot of... No offense, but you're quite young, quite naive.
Oh, you haven't seen the people I came with.
And he kind of...
One of them's a talking dog.
Ah, I can smell them.
Yeah, so can I.
Mm.
Smell baloney and...
Piss.
Mm-hmm.
One of them has spoiled himself.
I think I know which one, yeah.
But I like you, young man.
Thank you.
I like you. You know, I like the way you smell.
Hmm.
Mm. Again, he's kind of just looking at that little cut there. Yeah. He's like, I'm going to give you this. If I can find it. It's in my thing. It's right here. There it is. Okay. I give you this.
Thank you, Vlad. It's...
Oh. It's my gift to say sorry for this. And in the hopes that maybe you'll survive the night.
Can I ask what this is? It's just an amulet.
It's the Shining.
The Shining?
Yes. It will make you shine.
The Shining amulet.
Yes.
Okay.
It shines.
Here's Dupree.
And what can I say? Can you tell me? I mean, I can just read this.
It is sunlight. It has power of sun.
Can I ask why you have this? Does this not have any effect
on
you?
Vampires. We're fighting all the time.
Uh-huh. How threatened do I feel from him right now?
I mean, you get the impression he's a bit weird, and he's got this big old grin. My God, like,
he seems
you know.
Lovely.
And I mean, if you want to make a little wisdom saving throw for me.
Wisdom saving throw.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting. I rolled a 14.
Okay, you failed it.
Okay.
Yeah, but you feel really, you actually feel kind of
comfortable. Yeah.
Like, yeah, like he's got this big dopey grin with the teeth, like you know, he's a card. You know, he just wandered in. It's fine.
Vlad, thank you for the gift, by the way. We'll be using that, because I'm pretty sure I have a spell that does just that. These people that have gone missing, did you ever meet them? Have you seen anything?
Oh, no, I only stay here for a couple nights. Right. Passing through.
It seems a lot of people have gone missing, too. Is this your doing?
Oh. Please, little human, please! To think I would not be so sloppy.
Cool. So which room's yours, by the way?
Oh, I think it's number one.
Carry on.
I'm good.
I mean, I don't know what to do with him, like...
No, I go.
Okay,
I go.
Goodbye.
But you need me, you call, little human.
We may be calling on your services, since you can, of course, see the dead.
I warn you.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of dead here.
I know, we've been downstairs.
And he just points up like, oh, yeah. If I was you, I'd run.
Okay.
Oh my God.
I'd run. Oh, the ghost is back.
Is he?
Oh!
Oh, you got me again.
And then he just walks out of the room.
See you later.
Well, he turns into a mist and just like goes out
under the door.
The
yeah.
Just, like, yeah. Okay, Duncan.
You mean Scruffy?
Scruffy.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
Well, I'm in my room. I'm gonna turn the tap on to get some, try and pour the piss down the sink because it smells a bit.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm a bit scared. I locked the door.
Yeah.
It's locked. No one can get in.
Doobie is cowering in the corner. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna, yeah, I'll pour some water out of the sink.
Again, like, you know, the pipes knock
it
a little
stays,
bit.
Does it stay green?
Yeah, it's still green.
Can I do like a nature check to see like if I know what the smell is or like what why it's green?
Go on.
11 plus wisdom, I think. Int. 9. I got minus 2 int.
Wow. Oh my God. Green.
I'm not a clever guy.
It's green.
I pissed in my sink. It's green. It's just green.
It's just a bit gross. It's probably because it's old.
All right, well, I reach into my back pocket and I pull out half a sandwich from earlier. And I just sit on the bed and just start eating it.
Just start eating the sandwich?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. After a little while, you hear a... on the door.
Hello?
Hello?
Who is it?
Hello, I need your help.
All right, hang on a sec.
Hello?
I go up and I unlock the door.
What you see in front of you is a beautiful, an absolutely beautiful elven woman.
A wooga!
And she's wearing a lacy nightgown.
Oh.
Lacy white nightgown, and she looks a bit worried.
Hello, what's up?
hello, Squire. Yes, hello. I'm dreadfully sorry to bother you right now. I'm staying in one of the other rooms, and I heard this dreadful noise, and I was just wondering, I just need some company right now. May I come in, please?
Oh, of course. Welcome. Don't mind the dog. What do you mean? Shut up, you.
Thank you ever so much. And yeah, she comes in.
Okay, I close the door. What happened? What did you hear?
There was a frightful noise. It was banging and then a scream. And it was terrifying.
Oh, jeez. Well, which room was this coming from?
It was coming from the room down the end of the corridor. That's where I am.
What number are you in?
Number 8.
Great, okay. Number 8 should be safe.
I'm terribly afraid, and you know what it's like, young woman travelling on her own. I could really use a big strong man like you to keep me safe.
Oh, yeah! Well, you know how it is. Would you like to stay in here the night?
Would you mind? I know that's terribly forward of me.
Of course not, no, I wouldn't mind at all. You can take the floor.
Really? I was rather hoping that I could stay in the bed.
With you? Oh, with me? Sure. Yeah. Do you like sandwiches? I got a big sandwich here.
She looks a bit confused, but like, okay.
Ham and I think parmesan, actually, yeah.
You like your food then? Oh. Well, of course you do, a big strong man like you.
Gotta stay strong, haven't I? Gotta stay strong. Doobie, I think I'm in here. You'll blow it.
Okay, so I guess you sit down on the bed?
Yeah.
Her? Yeah? Okay, she's sitting quite close to you. Quite. You know, definitely in that kind of. Yeah? Are you really good for it?
You couldn't see that.
That was smooth. Wow, Duncan.
Are you going straight for that?
Going for the boob.
You're going for the boob?
Yeah.
You're going for the boob?
Going for the boob.
Okay. Okay. Oh, my. I see. We are of accord.
Oh, well.
Yes. We have the same thing on mind?
Yep.
It is terribly dark and cold outside. What better way than to keep warm and safe?
Than sandwiches. Yes.
Yes.
How about I go down to the kitchen and get us some...
No. I think I have everything I need right here.
Oh, really?
And she leans in to kiss you.
Okay.
Are you going to resist or?
I am going to.
Pucker up.
Stick my tongue in her throat.
Wow. Yeah. Okay. So you do that and you can make me a charisma saving throw.
Oh, charisma saving throw. Mm-hmm. That is not going to go well.
See how good of a kiss it was.
Can I do a performance check as well?
No, you can make me a charisma
check. It's a 17. No, 16. 16. Not bad.
Oh, nice.
It's not enough.
I'm a good kisser.
Not enough.
It's because I had all that onion, raw onion earlier.
Oh, God. That's gross.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not okay. Pleasant. So, you go into kisser.
Mm.
And you're kind of just like, wow, in the moment. Like, you don't know who this woman is,
mm-hmm.
but like, you know, you've done the sexy thing before. This feels like, just even the kiss just feels incredible.
It's like eating brie and grape sandwiches. Mmm, one of the best ones with like, some kind of creamy sauce.
All that goes through your head.
Yeah.
And while you're thinking that, you kind of just realize like her fragrance is just like the most beautiful thing you've ever smelled. And it goes straight to your head and you black out.
No. Oh.
I'm going to pass you that.
Well.
Make sure nobody else reads it.
STD.
Right.
I've got AIDS.
back to Michael.
Back to me. I've occupied myself the last couple of minutes. I've been getting as much human hair from the tap as possible. I'm just covering myself in it. Like, I look like a dog. I'm just, literally posted it. Rolling around the floor. I think I'm Doobie. That's it. Yeah, I love that dog, and I always want to be him. So.
Are you making a lot of noise while you're doing this? Are you like wailing or anything? Like,
I don't know how noisy covering yourself in human hair is. Oh yeah, I'll be wailing at the same time.
You're just kind of giving.
Just saying Doobie, just over and over again. Yeah.
Okay.
Doobie, Doobie, Doobie.
Tom, can you make me a perception check, please?
Oh, a 9.
Okay. Yeah, you can kind of hear some like vague noise, but it could be anything. So why gibbering away?
Yeah, gibbering away, yelling, screaming, shouting. But I'm having a fantastic time. I'm sort of enjoying it. I'm terrified.
Okay.
But in the best possible way.
Okay, as you're rolling around the floor in your kind of like bed of hair.
How much hair was in there?
That was a lot. It's a tap full of.
Just a rope of hair.
Yeah.
He's like rolling around his arms.
I mean, I don't know how to approach this. Would you notice that it's gotten really cold in the room again?
He's warm.
I'm preoccupied with the hair.
Yeah.
But perhaps, I don't know, I'm slightly more alert because it gets a bit chillier.
Yeah.
And I look around in my
You can suddenly smell this absolute stench of rot and decay. And it's overpowering like the smell of the hair, the smell of the blood on the bed.
Where's it coming from?
Everywhere. Like, it's filling the
fills
room.
Fills the room. I think I'm a dog now. I'm going to start like digging at the mattress, like trying to get inside of it. I'm just going to create, looking for the source of the smell. Is there some like buried corpse inside
the mattress?
Yeah.
Okay. You please make me a strength check?
Ooh, I'm not good at that. So that's a zero.
A zero.
Not even a natural one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, son. So as you, in your madness, are sniffing around in this mattress, two torn, bloodied arms shoot out the mattress, grab you, and pull you into the mattress.
I scream, I start biting them.
You can't resist on a natural one.
Yeah.
You're so mad. You just, and they're so strong.
Oh.
It's just pulling you into the darkness, and it's just.
And I yell, Scruffy! Is that your name?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right,
come
yeah,
on,
good.
Man.
Yeah, sorry, I'm yelling it.
We've been together for days.
Yeah, I'm so
Perception
sorry.
Check from you. I'm
screaming it.
Oh, that is 22.
Okay, you hear from the opposite room, you hear Kerr screaming. You don't really know what he's screaming, but you hear him screaming.
Okay. Down Scruffy.
Just halfway through the campaign.
Okay, I think I'm gonna burst into his room then.
Mm-hmm.
So I suppose I go through the hallway. But
am I still blacked out at this point?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So I'm in his room, he's in the bed.
You see him like being pulled into the bed.
I'm struggling.
I am going to...
Dupree, is that you?
I'm just gonna...
You are technically still gibberish.
Sorry.
All right, I'm gonna go and just try and...
You've probably got about like 10 minutes.
Okay.
So is he like being pulled into the mattress?
Yeah, you can see these bloodied arms just
right.
pulling him in.
I'm gonna just...
And
like,
he's covered in hair.
Grab... I'm gonna grab just the two of his legs and
he's
just
a beast.
Pull him as hard as I can.
Mm-hmm. Little strength check for me.
That's the worst one to choose. Oh, 20.
Ooh,
jeez.
Mm. Natural 20?
No, just
or
19
unnatural 20.
Plus one.
Okay, cool. Okay, so you grab whatever bit, I think it's his foot, it's really hairy.
Yeah,
why
yeah.
is he covered in hair? I don't know. but yeah, you start pulling and you can hear like a kind of screeching noise coming from the bed, like a really unnatural kind of like, you know, like, and, but yeah, you can feel him, you can feel that you're winning, you're pulling him out, and he's slowly but surely being pulled out of the bed. But he's talking gibberish. Like, it's just, yeah.
Is there anything I can do to, I mean, is he out or no, he's not?
You manage, after a kind of good like 5 minutes of
5 minutes
yanking and put, it's a tug of war.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
whatever these arms are, they want him, like, you know, they're like really hanging on. But slowly but surely, you get kind of purchase onto the bed and yeah, you lever him out, boof, pops out.
Okay, so he's got 5 minutes of
Booth pops out.
Yeah.
I mean, what do you do, I guess, when you are...
I don't know. I'm insane, so I'm probably pretty scared of you too.
Right, okay.
So I'm sort of impeding you, but I'm also not, because I'm more scared of the bed. And I'm saying... I'm not saying save me, but imagine that... Scruffy!
Okay, I'm just going to grab him and just pull him and leave the room.
Am I awake now?
Mm-hmm. All right, I'm going to pull...
I hear him shouting Scruffy and I'm
struggling, but
burst
I'm
out of
weak.
My room to see what's going on. What's happening?
Scruffy, it's good you're here. Something terrible has happened to Mr. Kerr. He has just been dragged into his room. Also, pretty sure I met a vampire.
casual.
Pretty sure.
What is going on? I'm terrified and I'm running away. And I'm running away from everybody down to this end of the hallway.
Okay.
We should follow him upstairs. And then Doobie comes out in the room, and he's like terrified. He's chasing his tail. He's
right.
Whimpering.
Teeth bared.
He's got a sandwich in his mouth, so you can't really tell. But like,
how is he reacting to you?
He doesn't like me. He doesn't want to get near me, really, but he wants to kind of try and follow me because he's like he's been trained.
Right. Can I roll like an insight or arcana or?
Do you have any spells or anything?
I've got detect evil and good, but I mean I need to sort of.
What are you trying to roll for?
Well, I just see something. See if something's not quite right with him. Because he's just come out and he seems completely calm, almost, when normally he'd be terrified. And also, his trained dog is also acting terrified, like, really weird.
If you're not doing a spell, I'd probably say insight?
Okay. 15 plus, 18.
18?
Yeah.
Yep. Something's not right here. Your gut instinct is, you know, you've been working with these two for a while.
Mm.
He's normally an idiot, but he seems really together and like he seems almost like a different person. And you've never seen Doobie act aggressively and towards him.
Okay. I suppose, does he take an action now or like?
Duncan, what, he's taking a good old look at you.
This isn't good. We should probably head up. Follow this guy. Let's go. Let's find out where this guy's going.
Gotta say,
come on, man, you look strong. You can get up there.
Gotta say, Scruffy, you're acting.
Oh, you think I'm acting weird? That's fine. Like, I met a girl last night. She's changed my life.
You met a girl.
Oh yeah.
Surely not.
Beautiful.
That scruffy. Sorry, guys.
He's snapped out.
I just felt really strange. I thought it was a dog for a second or something, but
it's covered in hair.
Scruffy girl. I don't believe this.
Oh, she was beautiful. She was smart. She was clever. She was smart.
Smart and clever and smart. Wow, she sounds
she
like
had it all.
She had it all.
She had boobs.
Okay, I'm gonna sort of like put a hand on like Mr. Kerr and slowly back down the.
Don't touch me!
You're not Mr. Kerr. You're Scruffy.
sorry. I thought you were gonna touch me there. Jesus.
Jesus Christ. I mean, Paylor.
Yeah.
Steve's like having an emotional breakdown in the corner. Head bones.
Oh, God.
Sorry, Steve.
I need to cast.
Sorry, I thought you were going to touch me there. Don't worry. Sorry. Don't worry about it. Just, I'm feeling a little delicate.
Scruffy, if you would, just stand there for a second and, you know, spooky ghosts. In this room, I want to see you. That was a spell I cast earlier to take.
Oh, okay. Good. yeah. Okay. So, oh, hold on a minute. I forgot to give you.
What's this?
Don't flip it. Ah, someone's got to go for a pee. Someone's got a tiny bladder.
All right. Well, I guess I'm sort of like backing down the hall slowly as I'm doing this and sort of nudging.
Backing away from.
Nudging Mr. Kerr with me.
Yeah. Okay, so your spell activates, and you see Scruffy in his kind of big, you know, he's a big guy.
Yeah.
And you can see that there is like a kind of a second glowing outline, like within him.
Right.
Like you can see it's really weird. It's like two figures just overlapped, and it kind of makes you feel a little bit sick. Because it's really unnatural, like it you just see these forms just blended together.
Like this, yeah, okay.
What did you just do? What did you do? What was that?
Scruffy.
You can tell me.
I can. I mean, what do I do? Like.
I run away. I'm gonna run, I'm gonna shove past them.
You shoving past them?
Shoving past them. Are you gonna stop me?
Strength. Check with Scruffy stats.
Aye, aye. That's 12.
Okay, can you make a strength check as well?
Yeah, I would like
both of you actually. Can you make strength checks? Because he's pushing past you, so.
9.
17.
What did you make?
12.
Okay, so he knocks you into the wall, but he just comes up across this tiny little gnome.
Somehow I must have all the strength
in the kneecap.
I have. I think I sort of trip him a little bit.
Yeah, you kind of stumble a little bit, but you don't get past Kerr.
Kerr. I push him back. So what? Why? Why did he come upstairs?
I just need to get out of here. I'm not feeling well. Can I jump over him?
Make an acrobatic. Acrobatics? Yeah, acrobatics. Check.
All right. It's a 7.
And Mikey, I'm guessing you're going to try and stop
well,
him.
Well, I'm going to cast like a minor illusion.
Okay.
And I'm going to like try and make, like reverse the hallway. Can you do that minor illusion? It's probably a bit
that's
a bit much, isn't it?
It's like a 5-foot size thing.
Okay, I'm going to, if he's doing an acrobatics check, I'm going
to
do like a
jump over your head.
A triple backflip off the wall because I'm a rogue.
Oh my God.
Wow.
And like sort of push him. Rogues can do that. I make my own acrobatics. Oh, it was a 7.
What did you make?
I got a 7 as well.
I got a 7 too.
Okay, so who has the higher dex?
I got dex of 14.
Me, I got 16.
Okay, so yeah, you go to jump over Kerr, and Kerr for some reason decides to do a triple backflip off the wall.
I'm a rogue.
And in doing so, manages to clip your head, so you just fall over, you trip over, and like, yeah.
Right, I'm going to, in that time, jump on him and pin him down.
Okay.
Mr. Kerr, there's something wrong with Scruffy.
Yeah.
Get off me!
I can see that. Where's his mutt? What's the dog doing?
Get him, Doobie!
Oh. Shouldn't have said that.
He's like, reluctantly, but also he's kind of compelled to run up to you and try and drag you off me.
Dupree, I think he's possessed. Is there anything you can do?
I know he's possessed. I used... detect evil in
you. Can you exercise him?
How would I go about exercising?
I hate exercise!
Do you have any spell like dispel evil or turn undead or anything
like
that?
I have banish, but I don't really want to cast that on him.
Banish would do it. Do you not have like turn undead or
anything
like that?
I think I am meant to have a turn undead. I've got speak with the dead, but...
Well,
it's not really going to help them. I've got loads of healing. I've got a blanket.
Oh, yeah. I would say banish.
Banish? It's my level 4 spell. Yes, so banish, yeah. You have to do a charisma save.
Oh, you got it.
Banishment.
Yeah, banishment, that's the one.
A charisma saving throw or be banished. Okay.
So using this stance?
I'm guessing, yes.
Ooh, good luck.
Oh, no.
Oh my god.
Natural 20.
Does that use a spell slot as well?
Yes. But you're going to act it out for me because that's what I want.
Whatever manner a beast is possessing our good friend Scruffy, and I'll grab my book and my
symbol.
I'm going to place it on them and just like hold it against them. Be gone from this realm.
Scruffy's head and turns completely around.
Oh god.
In a 360. And then vomits all over you. Oh. Completely covering you in like green vomit.
I'm terrified. Come, you could do it, Dupree.
Leave this realm, this plane of existence. Get back to where it is you should be.
Your mother sucks the devil's cock.
What would it be? Asmodeus.
Asmodeus is cock.
And I'm just like yelling louder and louder, just basically the same things on repeat. Just like yeah.
Vlad kind of sticks his head out from the end of the corridor. Nope. Sticks his head out and just shuts the door.
I ain't helping them fools.
So you use up one spell slot. Do you want to do it again?
What happens when it doesn't work? Just nothing.
Do I get an action?
Hold on a minute. You attempt to send one creature to a plane, another plane of existence. Mm. If the target there. Is native...
If it's wait. Native to that plane, it goes there forever. But if it's not, then it goes there for a short time.
I don't know, it doesn't really say. It doesn't say what happens, but I imagine, yeah, it's just a banishment.
Well, I rolled a 20 on my save, so...
It just doesn't work.
Yeah, it just doesn't work.
So does he get an action then, other than throwing up on me?
Was Scruffy speaking in Scruffy's voice when he spoke then? Was this a different...
He's speaking in a very feminine voice.
Wait, Scruffy, is that you? Are you in there? Can you hear me? It's me, Kerr.
Hello, you.
Hello, you. Oh, hey, Scruffy.
Hey.
What's wrong?
I'm doing good, man.
You're doing good, you're vomiting everywhere and talking about the Asmodeus's cock.
He just cast some shit and spell on me, man. I don't know what he's doing. Come on, come with me. Come with me. Come upstairs.
What's upstairs?
Come upstairs.
Has he got a sandwich in his pocket?
No, the dog has it.
Okay, I'm going to call the dog over. I'm going to grab the sandwich. I'm going to just wave it under his nose.
The dog bites you.
The dog bites me?
Yeah.
You took a dog's sandwich, dude. He does that.
So I saw nothing wrong with the dog.
Roll an attack from the dog.
He's just a dick.
The dog just looks a bit scared and a bit confused and a bit... he's freaking out a little bit.
Can I use mimic speech to mimic Scruffy's speech to ask the dog to give Dupree the sandwich?
My AC is 14.
Can I do that?
You can do it, but you can act out for me. Don't you paying attention to
I'm
what
just, this dog is biting him first.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hit him.
Wait.
It's 1+5... 9 damage.
I'm
taking 9 damage. Okay.
How can I bite him if he has a sandwich in his mouth?
He tried to, he took it out of his mouth.
Oh, so I've got
oh,
the sandwich.
Oh, so you've got the sandwich. Oh, wait, so I'm going to say, how does Scruffy speak?
Like, I don't know.
Bit of a stoner.
Yeah.
Oh my god, dude!
Dilby! Stop biting on that Dupree. You know he's a good man.
Is that stoner?
Let him vent. That was my question. Duncan. Yeah. Stoner. Yeah, dude.
There we
stop,
are.
Stop biting Dupree, man. Let him take the sandwich.
He completely ignores you.
But I'm doing mimic. I'm an expert in mimicking speech.
He has a bond with me.
He's got a bond. Yeah. Okay, yeah, that's fair enough.
Smells.
Okay, so I go over there and I grab the dog and I try with all my might to put him off Dupree. Oh, actually, I'll tell you what. I can grab the sandwich.
Well, did I get the sandwich?
I'm gonna say yeah. Being bitten.
Because when I bit you, you had to drop the sandwich.
All right. Well, one arm still currently being bitten. I guess he's like grappled on my arm. The other arm, I guess, has got the sandwich. Mm-hmm. I'm just gonna like wave it in front of like the like Scruffy's nose and just be like, I know you're in there, Scruffy. Come on out,
Scruffy. What are you doing? What's going on?
What's Scruffy doing?
He is vomiting still, just everywhere.
Okay.
It's fucking. It's like a fire hydrant.
Okay. Cool. You paying attention to the fact that there's a sandwich in front of you?
It just gets blasted away by the stream of puke.
So you've probably been puked on now. Lad sticks his head out again. Shuts the door.
I'm just gonna punch him in the head and try and knock him out.
Yeah?
I'm just gonna knock him out.
Okay.
Whose stats do I use?
I would say it would be Scruffy's, because physically it's Scruffy.
So it's AC 18.
Mm-hmm. 18?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I've got a shield. I guess would the shield be like inactive since I'm on the ground?
Yeah,
like,
yeah, your shield's not there on you.
So it's 16.
16.
So, alright. I guess plus what my strength. Mm. 11.
You miss.
Yeah, you miss. He's rolling around and there's a lot of puke. You slip on the puke a little bit and it's gross.
Can Scruffy attempt to break free of the grapple?
Yes.
What is that?
That would be
athletics or
I'd say almost a strength. If you're breaking free.
So athletics or then.
Yeah, athletics.
Right. 20.
Wow.
Natural 20.
Right, with your supernatural strength and puke,
yep.
It's like, flipping pancakes. You just flip him off.
Just blast him out of my
blast
puke.
Him out
he hits the
puke.
Ceiling. He's like stuck to the ceiling by puke.
And then it's like in Nightmare on Elm Street when Johnny Depp dies to the blood bed. Oh. It's like that, but with puke.
So I jump up and I sprint towards the stairs and I start running up them.
Okay, so yeah, he gets away. So he's up the stairs, gone. Mm. What are you guys doing?
And the dog, does that follow him?
The dog is like currently like grabbing you with his teeth.
Oh right, well.
I try and wrench him off.
If he sees you run, would he go as well?
He hasn't seen me run yet.
Okay.
It's like two people in front of him.
He's not done with us yet, Kim. Don't try and be friendly and helpful.
If he sees me run, he'll probably try and follow, yeah.
So he's still grappled. Do I take continued damage from him? Still?
No. He's attacking. It's just he's not actually grappling. He's just.
Like, oh, okay. I'm gonna just like try and shake him off.
I'm gonna try and help prise him off Dupree's arm.
I would say make a strength check for the dog, and if you two make
8.
Athletics.
I got 11.
I've got a 9.
And you got
8.
Okay, between you, you pull the dog off. And you're free, but covered in a lot of puke.
Right.
And so you saw Scruffy run upstairs.
Oh, he's gone. What about, does Doobs notice that he's gone?
Doobs looks up and he sees there's no Scruffy. And he's like, Scruffy! Scruffy, where are you?
You just hear the dog barking. No one talks dog here.
Okay, what are we doing? Should we see if there's any assistance in the rest of the tavern, or should we run after our fantastic, loyal friend?
I guess we just go upstairs. Like, we got to save him, and he told me that there's loads of creepy stuffs going on upstairs.
While you're debating this.
Mm-hmm.
You hear a very strange sound coming from that end of the corridor.
What, Vlad's end?
It's a very liquidy sound. Kind of like gloop and like kind of like that. You gonna look? Or are you gonna bicker?
I'm gonna, if I heard it, I'm gonna look. Mm-hmm. Like.
So from the other end of the corridor, while all this chaos is going on, you suddenly realise that there is a wall of crimson coloured fluid just suddenly pouring down the corridor, quite slowly,
sort of like a snowdrift, or like, you know, like liquid-hard magma. Okay. But yeah, it is just, it's coming down the corridor towards you, and it's blocking off the end of the corridor. Please put that down at the end of the corridor.
This one.
Oh, just a wall of that ooze, there. Okay.
Okay. That's it, I think we're going upstairs.
We're not going elsewhere, are we?
Yeah, yeah.
It's crimson and it stinks of iron and copper.
Okay, I'm just gonna, yeah.
It probably doesn't move that fast.
It's on you, you're dead.
I don't suppose I can, just before we run upstairs, do whatever check I'd need to try and identify anything about it.
I mean, you're looking at a wall of red crimson liquid.
It's just
that smells like blood.
A wall of red crimson.
And it's coming towards you.
Right.
It's fluidy.
I'm assuming you can assume it's blood.
Yeah.
Can I check to make sure it's not an illusion?
Yeah.
Is that just perception?
Perception.
Was that insight? I don't know. It was four.
Probably an insight, actually.
It was insight 17.
Yeah.
It's the real deal. I best guess people to go upstairs. Let's do it.
There's an intelligence to it. You can see it's kind of moving purposely towards you.
Really?
It's not just like a kind of fluid that's just like slopping all over. It's coming for you.
Okay, all right, I start sprinting upstairs.
Doobie's way ahead of you. Woo, jeez! Scruffy was blood!
Yeah, I'm following.
So sad, Tom.
I mean,
you have to fight everything.
I know, it's just, oh man, I didn't want to go.
Sure, you don't want to fight this.
No, I don't.
Okay, cool. So you run upstairs. I haven't had time to draw the upstairs, but if you would just picture, it's pretty much the same sort of shape that you've seen so far in the two layers, kind of following this long, kind of, I guess, corridors. Mm. Quite low beams, though. You get the sense that you are at the top of the building. And it's low, you can feel the ceiling kind of like that. Mm. What you see in front of you is a long room that's sort of like partitioned off but furniture rather than actual walls, kind of like to make little rooms. Right at the end of the room, so if you're kind of, because you've come up sort of like here, at that end of the room, you can see something is, the wall is kind of being covered up by boards, and you can see light, a really kind of like blemished light coming through it. And before that, you see kind of probably about here, you see a figure sitting at a desk. Their back is to you, and you can hear like frantic scratching like at some paper, and it's
all work
like,
and no play makes Jack a dull boy.
It's like a feather on a quill on parchment.
So okay. This is the size of this, but completely.
Yeah.
Open
so if you imagine, yeah. So
right.
Probably about the same dimensions. Like the boarded up bit is like right at the back there.
Yeah.
And
where am I at this point?
Can we see Scruffy?
Yeah. I imagine Scruffy is probably about there. You guys are about there. Doge is about there.
Doobie.
And if we put that there, and I'm not going to put the figure down yet because you guys need to recognize if you can. No.
It's just a little fucking model of Stephen King.
Yeah. You just imagine, and then like yeah, if you just imagine that this is like a big open space, but like bits of furniture and stuff like that, beds and. Maybe if I just quickly do like this, and then it's like the theater of illusion.
There's a bed.
Look at that.
Look. I'm just put some crates in the corner.
Some serious feng shui in here.
Yeah.
Well, it is an attic. It's essentially a long attic, so. Yeah.
A latic.
Nice.
There you go. Theater of illusion.
Cool. Okay. Oh, I like that.
And what's.
It's probably about.
Yeah. What's Scruffy actually doing right now?
Treasure.
Scruffy, what are you doing right now?
Scruffy is. He's just gonna stand here, turn around, and say, "Hello, welcome to the attic."
It's not. There's not a corridor there, by the way. It's like it's open. It's just like so. It's not a set.
Right.
Like,
okay, leave that then.
Yeah.
Welcome to the attic.
Welcome.
You've come exactly where I wanted.
Scruffy, what's wrong? I thought I knew you. What are you doing? Come back to us. What's wrong?
I. No.
I feel fine. Nothing's wrong. Welcome to the attic. Come in, come in. It's a beautiful place. Look, there's a bed, there's a chest, there's a drawer. There's not even a barrel here.
It certainly is beautiful.
Check out the barrel. It's full of things.
I slowly start to walk forwards.
While he's doing that, I'm going to... Whatever it is that is currently inhabiting Scruffy's body, I know you're in there. What is it you want with him? Or indeed with us?
What are you talking about? I'm fine, I'm Scruffy. I like sandwiches, man. I got a dog. What are you doing?
I carry on walking forwards. Make a perception check on the guy sitting behind Scruffy. Is he too far away or?
I reckon you could probably do it.
You can do it? 23.
Okay. What you can see is, you can see the back of Jack Will.
Mm. That's
and
where he is.
You can see that he is frantically writing like on something on his desk. Mm. And you can see he's kind of like really, like he's really into
what he's writing.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can also see an axe leaning up against the desk.
Okay.
How dark is it in here?
Pretty much the same as everywhere else. Like, you know, it is lit, but with these kind of dim oil lanterns and stuff like that. So
I may as well try it. I've got 3 charges on the thing. I want to use my shining amulet.
Mm-hmm.
So when activated, the amulet emits a blinding light, mm-hmm. like concentrated sunshine that lasts 10 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just going to say to Mr. Kerr, just, you know, cover your eyes. I'm going to also do the same for myself. And I'm just going to use the light.
And you're covering your eyes?
Maybe not. Well...
And are you directing it towards anything, or...?
I mean, does it emit a blinding light in like a circle or like a cone?
Kind of a ray. Like if you imagine the amulet, like a circular amulet. Like,
all right.
Like
so
that.
A cylinder. I mean, no then.
Yeah.
I just... Can I do like a perception check on the room in general?
Roll me some perceptions.
18.
Hmm?
18.
Mm-hmm. You notice it's definitely a living space. There's kind of, you know, a bigger bed in this side and chest of drawers, wardrobe, that kind of thing. Very, very messy, like all the clothes are kind of thrown everywhere. And then further down this side, you see a smaller bed. This looks like a kid's area. Again, there are toys everywhere, little kind of drawings and stuff like that. And there is also a little teddy bear
mm-hmm.
sat almost reverentially on the little bed. And then, yeah, at the end you see, as I said, some kind of glowing coming from the far end behind these boards, and Jack Will sat at a desk.
Right. Scruffy, where is it you want us to go?
Is it here? Yeah. Follow me! and I just lead them this way.
To the end, to the
as light. As he walks past Jackal doesn't seem to even like pay attention. He's so engrossed in what he's doing. You can hear he's kind of mumbling to himself as well.
Can I hear at all what he might be saying?
Probably not from that distance.
Okay.
Can I like sprint up to him and I want to try and grab the quill from out of his hand?
Okay.
Yeah.
Make me.
Don't touch him!
Oh, Jesus Christ. in addition to that, so that's all going to happen at once. So you sprint up to him. I would like you to make probably a dex to try and snatch.
What about sleight of hand?
Yeah, okay, yeah. Sleight of hand.
That's an 18.
Okay. So you sprint past. I'm guessing you do some cool rogue stuff.
I'm like
vault
doing some flips, like a slide at one
Look
point.
Look really cool.
This really is fucking badass.
Okay, cool. And you snatch the quill out of his hand.
Yeah.
Okay. And as you're landing, this one screams what he just screamed.
Yeah.
Don't feel
like you have to do it again.
No, poor Steve.
And Jack will just Jack will just looks up and is just like, you can see he's gone mad.
He's
like
gone
he's
crazy.
Got red eyes. He's got scratches down the side where he's like scratched himself. And he's just like, he's just instantly like, he's still writing even though there's no quill in his hand. And he's just like, he's just looking like this and he's grabbing for the axe.
Oh shit. Wait, which side of him is the axe on?
Left.
Can I like try and kick it away from him?
Probably not.
Probably not.
Still too busy landing.
Too busy landing.
Can I, in that case.
In fact, that's a brilliant time to roll initiative, everybody.
Oh shit, okay.
Nine.
Eight.
What plus is initiative? Is it dex or is it plus wisdom?
Dex. Yeah.
So I've got 12.
What did you get?
Eight.
Okay, so it's you got 9.
Yeah.
Okay. So the first thing you're gonna see is you're gonna see this absolutely insane dwarf grab his axe and just spin around, and he's just madly spinning around. He sees you two standing that side of the desk, he sees you and the wolf down the other side, and he's just spinning, and he's just, he's not gonna do anything yet, but he's just going mad. He's like, and he's just mumbling under his breath, like, he's like, it's my fault, it's my fault, it's all my fault, it's all my fault, like that.
So he has grabbed the axe then, though?
Yeah, oh, he's got the axe. Yeah. He is with axe.
He is not sans axe.
I never met his kid, did we?
Well,
did you?
Did we?
Okay. Sorry, is it me to go first?
Yes, it's you.
And where's this teddy bear? It's back here on the bed.
Is that the kid?
So I'm gonna try and move away from the crazy dwarf. Do I have to disengage?
I'd say you probably landed like on the other side of the desk, so yeah, you could, you probably move without him disengaging. He's so distracted anyway, he's just like madly spinning around.
I'm gonna come over here, I'm gonna grab the teddy bear as well. They've been too much into this, nothing happens whatsoever.
You pick up the teddy bear.
I put it in my satchel.
And yeah.
And then I run back here.
Do you, is that enough movement?
That's probably, so I can run 25.
That's
no way.
Not that.
Oh really? Oh, these 5 feet.
You'd probably be about like near the bed.
I'm gonna stand here.
Dunk off.
Okay. I look up, my eyes are wide, and I say, "Where am I? Quick, guys, come over here. We have to stop this. Get over here, quick!" And I go through it to this. Is it this thing
so
here?
So it's like kind of very shabbily. Put up boarded wall, and like you can see through.
Shoulder barge.
Very easy to like, to knock through. I'm not even gonna make you roll for it. Right. You roll through, and what you guys can see is you can see that there is definitely something at the end there. You can't quite see. You can see lights, but you can't see what.
Can I roll to see if that was sounded anything like him, like he's meant to sound, or if that was still something not quite right about?
Oh, you straight up, it's still that weird floaty voice. Like, right. Still, yeah. I'm guessing it was right. Yes.
So I can't roll to check if that was actually him or if that was still the ghost controlling him or whatever.
I'd say you could tell it. I don't know. Roll. Roll.
Roll insight.
Roll insight, yeah.
Oh no. Insight. 9.
So I roll something.
Right.
Well, there's so much going on.
Hang on, let me roll them. Deception. 10.
Yeah, he beat.
You think it's real?
Well, you know. You can so far see Kerr has gone and picked up a teddy bear. What you think is Shaggy has. Shaggy?
Scruffy.
Scruffy.
Jeez.
Sorry.
No one knows my name.
Has smashed a hole through the back of the.
Thingamajiggy. Oh, he's just gone through, has he?
You got a dwarf who's just going absolutely mad over here. And yeah, the dog's just like, just running around. The dog doesn't seem to know what to do. Like, he keeps running forward, running back, running forward, running back. Doesn't really know. What would your character do?
You think I'll tell the truth?
Yeah, okay. In that case, I would just continue down the hall, I guess, towards like the dwarf, but like, you know, still being wary that he may come at me. Mm-hmm. So I've got my shield, so I'm gonna just keep holding that up. Mm-hmm. Just walk down the hall.
What's your movement?
It's 30.
25, 30.
Would that be slower if I'm sort of guarded, or?
You could dash to do 60.
Dash if you want. Speed behind Jack.
Yeah, I'll dash, but then sort of end up right here.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go round this guy.
Okay.
I've got an axe.
So Jack Will is just sort of like, he turns around to face you two, Kerr and Pri. And he's wielding the axe, but he's very kind of like, he's just kind of like really twitchy with it, like kind of, you know, and he's got really kind of crazy eyes, and he's like, it's my fault, it's all my fault, he's gone because of me, he's gone because of me.
Who's gone, Wills?
And before, well, just as you say that, he reaches out with a dagger and stabs himself.
Oh my god!
What? Oh, well, saves me a job.
Fuck.
Yeah. Well, in that case, I am going to... You're not going to like this. Can I do... where is
it? Actually, there's another thing.
Spare the dying?
Hello.
Ooh. Can I cast Spare the Dying on him?
I mean, he's dying. He's not dead.
Oh, he's not dead?
It takes a while for you to bleed out. Mm.
Spare the dying, stabilizes someone who's unconscious.
Can I, is he, right, so he's, can I just heal him? Like?
Yeah.
All right, I want to do prayer of healing.
So I'm gonna, hold on a minute.
Oh, it's not my turn,
though. It's not your turn.
It's not my turn, sorry, carry on.
Is it my turn? So, I'm gonna say, Will, is there any response if I try and talk to him? Or is it, you know, he's just stabbing himself in the throat?
He's gurgling quite a lot.
He's gurgling, yeah. Okay. I'm gonna run up the.
He's pretty much gone through his throat.
He's pretty much gone through his throat. Okay, I'm gonna sort of run up to him and sort of push him over.
He's already fallen.
He's fallen
yeah,
over.
He's stabbed himself.
I just want to get him out of the way, and I just want to look at what the hell he was writing.
He's bleeding out.
He's bleeding out. I'm just gonna read, have a quick scan of his documents. Is there anything notable in
what? It's covered in a lot of blood.
A lot of blood.
There's a lot of kind of very, his writing is like, is so undecipherable, but you kind of catch things like, you know.
Not and my and fault, I imagine.
Yeah, okay.
Things like, remember that advert you read in the news article? Things like that. You see kind of like, not my fault, not my fault. And then, yeah, his son's name. Just over and over and over again.
Yeah.
And you also see what looks like...
Brian Wilson?
Oh, yeah.
Rituals. Like, kind of like stuff that looks arcane and ritually. Like, you don't really know what it is, but it looks magical.
Looks magical. Mm-hmm. Dupree, maybe you should come have a look at this.
So what was the name that was written there for his son? I don't think we ever found out his name.
The name... and only Mike would know this because he's looking at it.
That's fair.
Danain.
Danain.
D-A-N-A-I-N.
D-A-N-A-I-N.
Yes.
Danain.
Danain. D-A-N-A-I-N. Right, well, it's not my turn yet.
I put the teddy bear on Jack Will's corpse. Just as, like, why not put them together?
Yeah?
Do I not want to do that? Maybe
you can do what you want, mate.
I'm gonna put it there. Put the fucking teddy bear on a bleeding man. Why not?
He can have it. I think he wants to be with his son now. This is the best I can do.
Mate. Okay.
Yeah.
Right.
So is it my turn now?
Mm-hmm.
In that case, I am going to.
Wait, no, it's Duncan's turn.
Okay. Well, I am smashing through here. I shouldn't rush. The roll initiative for old Doobie as well, by the way.
Oh.
He's next. and I shout, guys, come through! I need you!
Right, so that's your turn, I suppose.
Can I roll deception? Yeah.
Sounds pretty convincing.
Yeah, I'm
21.
Convinced.
You're pretty certain that Shaggy.
Scruffy!
Scruffy!
Come on!
Is in some desperate help.
Yeah. Is it my turn now?
Yes, it is. Now your turn. Well, what's the dog going to do?
He's just basically been following me the whole time, but he's kind of like, doesn't want to get too close, but he's kind of compelled to follow.
Right.
Now it's your turn.
Well, I am a cleric of the life school, or whatever it's called.
Yes.
Just a life disciple. So I'm immediately just going to rush over to this guy and try and heal him as best I can.
Okay.
So I'm going to use my prayer of healing, which allows me to target six creatures for D8 plus 3.
Okay.
So does that matter if I only select one person? Like, does that increase it? In that case, I might use a different healing spell. I think I've got a better one. No, in that case, I'm going to use Channel Divinity, Preserve Life. So I can heal 40 HP divided across all targets, but no more than half of the total. So I guess up to half of his health, I'm going to heal up to. Okay.
Do
you want? Yeah, all right, I'm going to channel divinity then.
Go on then.
I channel divinity.
Okay.
I'm speaking in tongues.
Okay.
Yeah.
What language is that?
Do you little rolls? You need to roll to tell me how much you're healing.
Oh, it's 40, but...
40?
Yeah, heal 40 HP divided across all targets that I choose.
That's quite a heal.
And, wow. But no more than half of their total.
Oh, right.
Okay.
Now, I'm not sure if that actually heals his wound.
Should do.
It will, yes. Yes, that will heal him.
Okay.
So yeah, you manage to stabilize him and bring him back up. So he takes a big breath and he's like, he opens his eyes, but he's like, no. No, and he's reaching for his knife.
I think, so do I have a bonus action?
Yeah.
Can I either slide the dagger away or like pin his arm down or...
What would you like to do?
Slide the dagger away.
Okay, that would be... something dexy. I guess you're just hitting it.
Should I just do dex?
Yeah.
13.
Yeah, you managed to pinwheel the knife away.
Yeah.
You have no idea what's going on. Why does this guy want to kill himself? Like, he's so desperate to die. right. So while this has happened, you put the teddy bear on the body, didn't you?
Yeah.
Put the bunny back in the box.
In all of this chaos, what you guys suddenly notice, well, you suddenly hear this booming laughter coming from around about where Duncan is, Scruffy. And you suddenly are aware of a dark form just appearing.
There. Oh shit, me! What is that?
That's a bright dark form.
It's honestly like the best I could find. I wouldn't. Don't take it as like a. This is what it looks like.
It's a mime tour.
I like it.
That's the best mini I can
find. I like it a lot. It's a cool mini.
And yeah, so what it is actually is a very dark kind of wraith-like form, misty, a crown on his head, dark ribs. You can see like these two burning eyes, but you can't quite see his face. Mm. And he just appears out of nowhere. And he's just laughing maniacally and he's like, ah, some new guests. Welcome to the Overlook Inn. And you also notice a smaller, similar figure up here. Could you put it by the bookcase for me, please? By the bookcase. And it's small. It's the same kind of like composition, but smaller. Almost childlike. And
Demian.
It's fucking scary, that's what it is.
Yeah.
Who's first to act?
Mikey,
all right. Is it an action if I just yell at Scruffy?
I'd say that's an interaction.
That's an interaction. Like, Scruffy, are you with us yet? Please say you are.
I'm with you.
All right, okay. Oh, fuck. All right. I'm going to bop up to this guy. I'll tell you what, I'm going to actually grab the teddy bear because you keep on saying it in such a weird manner. I don't know, and then I'm gonna like hover over here and see what happens after they move.
Okay, I'm guessing, I'm gonna say you could probably take it off because he's too busy trying to kill himself.
He's too busy.
So
like, okay.
I think he's prone now anyway, isn't he?
Okay, so you know what you notice is that the little wraith starts looking at you and starts kind of floating over towards you.
Okay, it's my turn's over.
Yeah.
I want to drop it, but.
Then it's Duncan. And dog.
Duncan, then dog.
Oh. He calls over. Come in.
Please, for God's sake, get over here. Jeez. What are you doing?
Do you want to make a charisma saving throw?
Right.
Okay. Carry on.
just spending his turn, just...
Can I do another deception check, then?
Yeah.
And these guys believe me pretty much up to now. And yet, they still won't come over here!
I mean...
That's a,
I feel like my character would try and heal the... I was going to begin with, until
15,
he tried to kill himself.
He's still trying to kill himself. Like, he did actually have a go before you, but he's just frantically trying to look around and trying to, like, get away, and he just, yeah. He's not looking to attack you, but he's kind of like, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
He's clearly trying to just shuffle off this mortal coil.
Right. So whereabouts is the dagger now? Is it over towards...
I'd here? Probably say, like, the left-hand side of the desk.
And it's my turn.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Pick up the dagger, take the bear off Mr. Kerr.
Mm-hmm.
I want to hold it hostage.
Yes. I'll kill it, I promise!
You do all that,
mm-hmm.
and the little wraith looks at you with such a look of malice and anger,
yeah.
and is now moving purposely towards you. And it is in fact his go. So I am going to roll some dice. Could you move the little wraith over to you, please? I'm gonna roll. Ooh, you might be alright. 9 to hit.
I've got 14 AC.
Okay.
So he is swinging at me.
He's reaches out a little hand, and he's trying to touch you. Like he's trying to get you. Back up to the top, it is actually it's probably big wraith. The bigger one is going to go over. Okay, the big wraith is going to go towards Scruffy. Scruffy? Okay. Scrappy?
Yes!
Scruffy!
Scruffy, not Scrappy.
He's gonna go
Jesus.
Towards you.
It's not that hard to remember.
It is if you mean.
Think of the janitor from Futurama. Then you got it.
Okay.
Scruffy.
Regular just porno.
And yes, okay. He's going to look at you, and he's going to know it's the woman that he's talking to.
Aye.
And he's going to be, May. How are you, my darling? I have a favour for you. Do you mind smashing this human form's hand into the mirror?
Of course.
It's not your go.
Oh.
Okay.
You see the wraith going, and you hear,
I see the wraith going,
you hear some voices, but you probably don't know.
Do you feel like you need help, Dupree?
I mean, just...
Okay, first of all, I'm within, like, melee range. And this is distracted, right?
So it's focused on Dupree.
Okay, so I'm going to make a sneak attack
mm-hmm.
on it.
Mm-hmm.
So to hit is a... Oh, my God, no. So my to hit is... 10?
Nope.
Ugh.
You kind of, you slip on a little bit of blood and yeah, you miss entirely.
Yeah, okay. And then I'm going to use my like cunning action because I'm a rogue to, sorry, Dupree.
Fine.
I'm going to run into here and see what's
are
going on.
Are you
going
to make it the whole way?
It's a dash, okay. So I think I'd probably make it to about here-ish.
Mm-hmm. So what you see is you see the Wraith talking to Scruffy.
Okay.
But you missed what they said.
What they said, okay. Yeah.
Duncan, it is your go. You want to smash your hand into the
ground? Yeah. Is it right there?
You could make me a strength check with Scruffy's stats.
Roger that. That's a 11.
11. The mirror cracks, and you get a cut on your hand that starts to bleed, but that's it for now.
Okay.
Okay. Tom, it is your go.
Can I do an interaction as well?
Yeah.
Before he does. Guys, come in!
I'm coming, Scruffy!
I'm waiting for you!
Roll section.
Oh, jeez.
Ten.
Yeah.
It's starting to be a bit suspicious.
Does,
especially when you just saw Scruffy smash his hand into the mirror and just be like, "Hiya!"
What does Doobs do? I think it's Doobs' turn now.
Oh yeah, Doobs. Doobs is just gonna like come into his room and like hide behind me and just kind of
cower.
Kind of like stand on two legs and just kind of put his arms in the air and go, "Oh jeez, what's going on?" That's it.
What's this guy doing?
He's dead.
I just realised I absolutely did not describe what was going on in that room. I'm so sorry to everyone. So what you see, so I'm going to take it from Mike's point of view, just looking around the corner.
What mirror?
What you see is a giant gothic mirror with an iron frame around it, just dominating the room. And you see on the floor, things have been written onto the floor, circles, symbols. You're not entirely sure, but it looks pretty creepy.
Yeah, okay, it's creepy.
Candles absolutely everywhere. Mm. And now that Scruffy has smashed his hand against the mirror, you start seeing forms and faces shape on the other side of it. Like,
oh, God.
Really ghostly, pale, kind of like they're coming to look up, and they're like, did you see the new Ghostbusters?
No.
There's a bit.
Pretty bad, right? Like
okay.
Yeah, but yeah.
Are there any like on the frame of the mirror? Decoration? No, I mean like the actual mirror itself.
The frame, it's just
plain
gothic, it's and just it's like, you know, curly gothic bits, and like it's heavy cast iron.
Okay.
Sorry, everyone.
I'm
a bit too excited.
Okay, I want to use.
So yeah, it's your go.
I want to use.
He's still trying to like blurble away on the floor.
Yeah, I want to use the shining amulet. And cast it as best I can, because he's not looking at me.
Mm-hmm.
It's only, I mean, he's not looking at me.
It
so
probably won't go through. Well, actually, you might.
There's like a cracked hole in the wall.
Yeah,
here.
Yeah.
Like, so I'm going to try and sort of angle it so it gets both him
and the figure that you see.
Yeah.
Okay.
There you go. One.
You're going to use that?
Yeah.
Okay. Where is it? Okay, yeah, you're like, sure, Vlad, and just hold it out, flip open the cover, and this beam of pure light just shoots out, and it's hot, and it's bright, and you notice the Wraith in front of you just kind of like, yeah! Like that, just like give a tiny cry, like, you know, it sounds like a young boy, and he's just like covering his eyes like that, and similarly, you hear in the other room, he probably just gets caught in the end of it. The bigger Wraith just like, yeah, like that, just kind of, you know, and starts to kind of, you know, trying to protect
himself. Does it affect me at all?
No, it does not affect you.
Okay.
I'm getting a tan.
Yeah.
Yeah, if anything, you're getting a little bit of a tan.
Dude, yeah, man.
Oh, nice.
Getting a tan.
Do I have enough actions to throw the bear down the room and also start heading towards, or just throw the bear?
I'd say it's probably an action to activate the amulet.
Mm.
I'd say probably a bonus action you've got left to do one or the other. You can't do both.
I move as movement.
Mm.
Yeah, you can move as well. So.
So I can throw and move, or no?
Would you say, Duncan, you're a bit more experienced than me?
Depends what you're trying to, like, if you're throwing it to someone, that could maybe be a bonus. If you're throwing it at someone, then that would be an action.
I'm just throwing it down the room.
I'd say
anything in particular.
Yeah. Okay. So yeah, just chuck it. Give me a strength to just see how far you chuck it.
11.
Okay, yeah, it'll probably land about there.
Right,
it's a barrel! Have you got anything like that can represent it? Like, This.
My bookmark. Yeah,
perfect.
Nice. Well, there you go.
Some
my
kind
giant.
Of ancient yeah. arcana.
It's a magical thing.
And yeah, I guess like move as far as I can with whatever.
Yeah, if you want to move up then. So you've got 30.
Yeah, so.
5, 10, 15, 25. Five, 10. So probably you'd be level with Kerr.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, okay, so the Wraith. Oh, actually, you need to do a disengage.
Oh, yeah.
But I'd say you have advantage because it's currently being blinded by the light.
Yeah. So what would I have to roll against?
Disengage is, what is it? It's
one. Jeez. Oh, I got a 16, so I guess that's the one I take, isn't it?
I'd say you disengage, yeah. So you manage to duck out the way and get past. So yeah, you run up. The boy Wraith, seeing the bear being thrown that way, is going to move towards it. So if you want to fluff him this way.
Oh, I see.
And then...
Clever.
Nice.
The other one is going to stand in the doorway to try and block you two, and is going to go and look at you. And I've got disadvantage, so 17, 15. Hmm. 15, 17, 20,
22
to hit.
22, well, yeah, bam, ouch. That hurts. Yeah, you really fucking
hit.
D8.
Where's my D8s? 1, 2. Come on. I don't know why. 1, 2, 7, 6, so that's 13. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, necrotic damage.
Ouch.
Oh, yeah.
Can you make a constitution saving throw for
so
me?
So, con saving throw will be 10, 12.
12. So.
Double.
Your hit point maximum is reduced by equal amounts. So whatever your hit points were.
My max is now 18 hit points.
Yeah.
What? I'm
currently on 18 hit points.
So you see this Wraith turn to you, reach yeah. out with his hand, and go, no, no, no. And you feel the life being drained from you. Oh. You feel like Indiana Jones when he drinks from the wrong cup and he ages. Like, you feel that. Your very life force is being pulled.
Yeah, well, this
you.
Is horrible. Yeah. Is it my action?
No.
It's like eating a
bounty. Actually, yes, it is yours. It
that's
is
me.
Yours. Yeah.
Scruffy, I'm going to make one last plea. I'm going to make a persuasion check and ask Scruffy. We've been together for so long through thick and thin. Do you remember all those haunted old amusement parks? Those creepy abandoned factories we've investigated. Come back to me now, Scruffy. This is a persuasion check. Okay. Come back to us. Like, we need you now more than ever. Do not break that mirror and come help us. Like, we need your help. Can I make a roll for persuasion? Or is this so...
Go for it.
Is this such demon... Oh God, it wasn't very good.
Didn't do anything.
Well, it would have been a 13.
I remember the good times, man. Come on, we need to break this mirror. It's the only thing that's gonna save us.
Duncan?
Deception.
He's not looking for it, so.
No?
Yeah.
Is it my go?
Yeah.
Take out my frying pan. Smash it against the mirror.
Okay. I guess that would be an attack roll then, with your frying pan.
12.
So given the crack already in the mirror, you lob this frying pan at the crack and it smashes. And as it smashes and all the glass falls onto the floor, you just hear the Wraith turn and go, yes, yes,
yes, yes, join me in the mirror room.
Ghosts flood out of the mirror. Just they and they're cackling and they're laughing and they're free and they just flood out into the world, and as they fill the room and as they come around you and they surround you and they look at you and they cackle and they grab and strike you, you realize it's all gone very, very wrong.
No.
And that is where we're going to end.
Oh,
because
no.
Not all horrors end very happily.
We all died.
Oh.
Oh my God.
Tom, you look devastated.
Fun.
Yeah.
Well,
There were various ways you could have stopped it. Uh-huh. You stopped it from being worse by the fact that you saved the dwarf, because wraiths have a technique where they can turn recently undead things into more wraiths. So you did very well there by bringing it back to life.
Uh-huh. You had to drop my body to zero hit points.
I didn't want to attack
you. Well, that's
the
thing.
Otherwise I was stuck with this ghost.
Or if the banish had worked, if the exorcism had worked, then you could have
I'm sorry, guys. I didn't want to do that.
How many hit points did you have out of interest?
76.
I was thinking about attacking him, but
But there was, but you know, that's the thing about horror is that it doesn't.
It doesn't always end.
It doesn't always end well.
That's cool. Fill us in on the rest of the tavern, Kim. So what was up with the haunted bed? Was it just a creepy?
The haunted bed. Oh, that was going to be a creepy thing. That if I didn't manage to get Duncan to kind of be possessed,
succumb,
then you were going to get pulled
if
into
I
this.
Somehow Duncan succumbed.
Like, if for some reason Duncan was like, "No, you're creepy, get out," like it was going to be like a portal that took you up to the altar room. It was going to be like, I would have had something happen. Like the wraith was going to try and get you to smash the mirror and stuff like that.
Nice.
And it was basically that the whole idea was that Jackwill was trying, he'd set this ritual up to try and get more ghosts, to get his place haunted, to attract the tourists.
Yeah, okay.
But it had gone horribly wrong, and this wraith had come through and killed his son, which is the little wraith.
Yeah.
So yeah, he was just trying to turn more people into wraiths, and then,
Nice, I thought it was really cool.
Have a little wraith army. It.
What about Vlad? Was there anything extra with him?
He was just a guest.
He just wanted
in. So I was in the best room.
He's just happy-go-lucky, you know, really, really happy for life.
Yeah, I did kind of like him.
He was like, you know, well, he was
you say you're in the best room.
Yeah.
I got a feel, so.
Well, you can't have misery and doom and gloom every, like, I wanted someone to have a nice experience. Obviously, if you'd attacked him, it would have gone very wrong.
Yeah.
You know, I think maybe if you'd bled a bit more, like, if you'd fumbled a bit more, he probably would have been a bit like, midnight snack.
Smelled pretty good.
But also, I mean, this whole thing was a riff off of The Shining. Yeah. So he was playing Halloran's character. So he was the guy who was like, "You got The Shining."
Who was I playing? Who was I?
The naked woman in the bathtub.
And who are the twin girls?
I like it. They were the twin girls.
Yeah. So I don't know if you noticed, the rooms were 2, 3, and 7.
There was a lot of enough that I've seen it once.
Yeah, there was a lot of little things I put in there that's not necessarily like. And the blood. That was actually going to be upstairs, but you guys were taking so long. I was like, sod it, blood.
Yeah,
I actually had that as an ochre jelly. So rather than a wall of blood, it was going to be like this thing that's actually going to dissolve
like
you
a slime
if it touched you.
Thing.
Like it's a slime, it's an ochre jelly. I had it all queued up, ready to go. I think my problem is though, is that I'm not good at guessing the time it's going to take for all of this. So I did rush
it. It's one of the hardest things in this game.
Yeah, I definitely rushed it at the end there where I was like,
It doesn't help that we were taking so long down here.
Yeah.
So, no, it's fine.
You can never predict like how long people
take to do something. I think you guys did some awesome RP. Like, I thoroughly enjoyed, like, you know, the Vlad thing and, like, you talking to the lady.
Awkward flirting. It's it's working. Yeah. It's working. It's never worked before.
I wrote that with you in mind because I was like, you're such a dog. I knew you wouldn't resist. Like, beautiful lady. But yeah, well, I hope you guys enjoyed
it. That was fantastic. Yeah, thanks.
Sorry if it was a bit rushed and a bit
it was really good.
Sketchy. Duncan, you need to go.
I've got to go and play
D&D. And play D&D. So apologies to Rillian and the rest if I've held Duncan up. But yeah.
Wasn't too much later, mate.
Are you guys okay to stay for donations? I'll
hold my own if not.
I hope you enjoyed that, guys.
No, it's really good. Thank you.
Thank you to Nightjar who donated with just a little heart. Thank you. And thank you to Star Monkey TV. Hey, Duncan, when's Flux Buddies 4, Kappa?
I don't know. Jeez. Soon? Does that help?
Lady Batress has donated. Thank you very much. I'm so excited to watch these three lovely gentlemen get spooked and bullied by Kim. I didn't bully you guys. I
weirded you guys out.
Yeah,
to be honest, you weirded me out with the whole hair. I think you took the madness thing way
me on
further
a bit.
Than I expected.
You put the hair. You made a hairy tap, like a hair. I thought that was a natural response to
well,
it.
Well, like, that was inspired by Japanese horror movies. Like there was one where there's a body up in the tank. Like
oh, and the hair comes.
Yeah,
oh,
it's pretty gross. Nice.
That's pretty cool.
Tom is precious though, so don't bully him too much. That'd be like bullying a puppy. I don't bully you too much, did I?
No, only when I'm Reynard.
Yeah. And then it's deserved.
Yeah.
And thank you to Sky Silverwing for donating. Kim is the most beautiful DM on the internet and her hair is perfect. Thanks, Mum.
That was actually me.
Oh, really? Yeah. Thanks. Thanks for the fiver. Oh, wow. We have a hundo, guys.
Oh,
a hundo.
Way.
So thank you to Pixie MLG Gamer. Who's one of my regulars, actually, on my stream. So thank you for tuning in. Good day, Rollers. It's Pixie here. Yes, I can't watch live today, but I'm ready to wet myself in fear when the VOD comes out. I hope you all enjoy the maple hundo. So they're in Canada, so we call it a maple hundo.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Because of maple syrup.
Yeah, because Canadians eat maple syrup. Yeah. Kim, I love all of your spooktastic one shots and look forward to the next one. Hopefully, my next one will be a lot more together. I felt a little bit.
I think it's good.
Out of my depth. Do you want to read some, Dunk, or are you packing up?
I'm packing up.
Okay, okay.
Yeah. Sky Silverwing donated $5. I find it odd that this group of new characters, completely unrelated characters, is somehow affiliated with the same group as the earlier groups. I still say they should have kept Duncan's character from last time on.
But he wasn't a member of the group. Technically, Herb was not a member
Herb
of the
Green.
Yeah.
Herb Green.
Was not a member of
the group. Oh, I was seeing a theme. Yeah. Oh, thank you.
He was just
he was a
teenager.
Ghost that at the end of the last session, he kind of moved on.
Yeah. He finished his business and he moved on. So, actually, I think he found.
You want your ghost back.
Yes,
I mean, I feel like this association hires all types, really, and we're just the next
Yeah,
I feel like it's also the sort of association which gets through, like, investigators so frequently that the turnover rate's really high.
Yeah, you get those who are, like, you know, just burnt out, and they're just like, I'm spooked, I'm out, like, too spooky for me.
And this is and just then, another failed investigation.
And then, you've got the three who are now dead.
Did I die?
I don't know, we could revisit that at a future date.
No.
We'll have to see.
I was possessed. I mean, I kind of imagined, you know... I feel like I've got a girlfriend now. Dylan Moran's character in Shaun of the Dead. I kind of imagined that sort of thing.
Oh, like me. Guts exploding everywhere.
Like torn to pieces. Yeah.
That was pretty gross, that scene.
It's weird that you played that kind of character. It's not like normal for him, is it?
Rom Rapara.
I love these mystery streams. You're a great DM, Kim.
Oh, thank you. I felt like I fluffed it today, but
you were very kind. It was good, but we were being a little bit more difficult, I think.
I did pull some things right out my butt where I was just like, you asked me something and I'm like, yes!
Yeah. Nice. You couldn't tell, Kim, it's fantastic.
Kid Kaboom 1 donated $20. Greetings to the great and powerful paranormal investigators. Thank you, Kim, for being such an excellent stand-in for Mr. Sherlock whilst he tries to bind the forces of the universe to a fake beard. You are all inspiring to the average neckbeard.
Oh,
my God. Is that a compliment? I don't know. And I'll do one more and then I'll pass it on. Jason G95. Hey, all. I got caught up a few months ago and been watching live since then. Just wanted to donate and thank you all for the great streams and good times. Thank you. Jason.
Thank you,
Jason. I need to hide that one.
Right. Okay, so Lightning Wolf has donated and said, just dropping in, we're going to have to watch the rest on the VOD. Kim, keep up the great work. Duncan, keep it in your pants. Nice.
We don't know when that came
Yeah,
in,
we did,
we?
Yeah. Then William donated.
She forced
said,
it out.
She did.
You could have walked away.
I don't know. She was hot.
So William said, was DM for my friends, so I couldn't watch the stream tonight, which is fantastic, but donating now anyway. I love Kim's one-shots, so I changed my donation name from KemTivWinshka to my Twitch username, William, so Kim doesn't bite her tongue trying to pronounce it.
I'm not so good at some of the Twitch names.
The Roy Master donated and said, well, looks like the shoes on the other Kim. What? What? I don't know. I'm not good at this.
Are you wearing shoes?
Hope you bunch of kiddos have fun or not. I don't run your lives, but Kim does hold them in her hands. Hope you had a fun Easter. Love all but one of you. Fight for my love.
Who? Who don't you love?
Who don't you love?
It doesn't say.
I think it's you, Duncan.
It's gotta be me, right?
It's gotta be you.
Probably. You'll be the last one, Kim.
Last one? Okay.
Sky Silverwing donated again. With the level of hostility and inhospitability these people showed the people they had called to help with the haunting, I would have left and probably set the place on fire when they realized that all the patrons were ghosts. Well, I had things in place. So if you guys were like, sod this, I'm out. I had.
Well, I ran upstairs, but maybe I should have run outside. Yeah, but then again, outside's even scarier.
It wouldn't have helped.
It's dark out there.
Well, also, I had planned that if you had run out, in the true spirit of The Shining, the book, not the film, there were giant magical hedge animals to chase you back.
I was kind of like seeing, like, in my mind, I was like, how is she going to freeze the main bad guy?
Well, I didn't want to be too, like, you know, step-by-step reenactment. I liked it. But in the book, like, for some reason, there's giant, like, living hedge animals that come after Danny. Like, in book. And, like, Stephen King was like, yeah, I'm really upset that the film didn't, like, you know, bring the book to life. And I'm like, you had giant...
I'm upset he didn't bring the hedges to life.
Yeah.
I'm like, well, that makes no sense, Stephen. Fuck.
Yeah, come on now. Right, yeah, so that is all our donations. So thank you very much to everybody who tuned in tonight. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what you think on our subreddit, which is reddit.com/r/highrollersdnd. I need to learn how to DM more, so if you've got any tips for me, let me know. Thank you very much to Mikey. Oh, yeah, you want people to follow you on Twitter, don't you?
Follow me on Twitter, guys.
Follow me too.
That's it. Follow Duncan, follow Tom, follow Kim.
It's Mikey underscore.
Oh, you did it!
Mikey
did
Fleming.
It. I was trying to do it earlier.
Oh, yeah. There we go. Amadeus Fink over here.
Yeah, got all the dice lined up.
It's nice. But yeah, thank you very much to Mike, Tom, and Duncan for joining me. We will be back next week, normal time as usual, and it'll be the usual High Rollers crew. So, Tom, you'll be back.
Yeah, I'll be
and
back.
We'll be seeing what happened to the kobolds.
Kobolds. Yeah, in the caves.
What's your Twitter again?
Man.
At Mikey Fleming.
Mikey Fleming.
Mikey underscore Fleming. Yeah, capital M, capital F.
Capital M,
capital
F.
Yeah, I know.
One M in Fleming, not two M's.
Okay, we're done.
Bye, everyone.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye.